Lions is ready to host the 38th annual State Farm Bayou Classic. Former Grambling All-American quarterback and Super Bowl MVP. The city of New Orleans is ready to host the 38th annual State Farm Bayou Classic. Former Grambling All-American quarterback and Super Bowl MVP Doug Williams is now the Tigers head coach and the father of their starting freshman quarterback. Southern University, just like Grambling, is also eyeing a first place finish. The game and all the pageantry coming up next. Right now, let's head to our New York studio.
Welcome to the U.S. Bank NBC Sports Report. Here's your host, Liam McHugh.
Hey, everyone. We'll get you right back to New Orleans in just a moment. But first, the major sports news of the day. We're just 2 days removed from Thanksgiving, and it appears that the NBA could be looking at a Christmas miracle. At about 3 o'clock this morning, the owners and players reached a tentative agreement to end the 149-day lockout. Under the new deal, which still has to be ratified by both sides, training camps would open on December 9th, and the abbreviated 66-game regular season would begin on December 25th. Turning now to college football, where nobody should be questioning LSU's supremacy. The number one Tigers have now defeated 7 top 25 teams and 3 top 5 clubs. Their latest victim, number 3 Arkansas. But early in the second, Michael Ford trucked by Tremaine Thomas. The ball pops right into the hands of Alonzo Highsmith. He takes it 47 yards the other way. Razorbacks off to a 14-0 lead. But just over a minute remaining in the half, game's now tied, and Jordan Jefferson hits Russell Shepard to make it 21-14 at the half. Early in the fourth now, Tigers pulling away. Jefferson fakes the handoff, goes 48 yards. LSU takes down Arkansas 41-17.
The State Farm Bayou Classic has an appeal all its own. A Thanksgiving weekend one-of-a-kind tradition in New Orleans. This year, it's also a family affair. Grambling's most prolific passer ever, Doug Williams, is now the head coach and the freshman starting quarterback's father. Southern has its own former NFL star leading the way. Stump Mitchell and his Jaguars eye their first Bayou win since 2007. First place on the line during the game and at halftime with the highly anticipated Battle of the Bands. The 38th annual State Farm Bayou Classic has arrived.
NBC Sports presents the State Farm Bayou Classic. The Southern Jaguars wearing white for the first time this year and looking for their first win in this rivalry since 2007. The Grambling State Tigers have won 5 consecutive games, 1 win away from a spot in the Southwestern Athletic Conference title game. And we thank you for being with us alongside Sean King. I'm Paul Burmeister. Every starting quarterback has a little extra pressure on him when he's at starting quarterback in that team's biggest game of the season. But imagine how that pressure would increase, Sean, if you were a freshman quarterback and your father was not only the head coach but the most accomplished quarterback in school history.
I cannot imagine the emotions going through the young man. The expectations, the whispers, will he be the player that his father was? I spoke to DJ during the week, and to my surprise, he said he's embraced these challenges. Actually, he's looking forward to the opportunity today on the big stage in the Bayou Classic to start to create his own legacy as a starting quarterback here at Grambling.
As Father Doug Williams, not only the starting quarterback in the very first Bayou Classic, but the winning quarterback back in 1974. His counterpart this afternoon, Stump Mitchell, brought with him to Southern last year when he took the Jaguar head coaching job. 20 years experience as an NFL running back and also assistant coach. A work in progress are his Jaguars right now in year two. How much progress do you see?
They've made a lot, and it has not happened as fast as Coach Mitchell anticipated, but he feels like his club now understands the expectation and the standard. Really confident that today they can pull the upset and find a way to get a victory and create a 4-way tie for the Southwestern Athletic Conference Western title.
Well, every year since 1974, Sean, when that Thanksgiving meal is finished on Thursday, the focus goes to Saturday, the Bayou Classic. Southern and Grambling moments away.
Southern and Grambling State started playing back in the 1930s. A bit of a tiebreaker here this afternoon. Series tied right now at 29. The head coach of the Grambling State Tigers is former All-American quarterback at Grambling, Doug Williams, and he's joined now by our Lewis Johnson.
Paul, thanks so much. Well, Coach, you guys wanted to be in this position back in August, but you fell to 1-4. How are you able to get this season turned around to put you in the position where you are right now?
Well, I think, you know, Coach Rob used to always tell us that the credit goes to the man in the arena. And I have to say that the young guys never quit. They worked hard, we practiced them hard, and nobody complained. And for that, last 6 weeks has been six great weeks for us.
You had some final words for your son, DJ, there. What were they?
Well, they was in some situations. It all depends on what they do and just tell him what he has to do. You know, just game plan type of stuff.
All right, good luck managing all that today.
All right, thanks.
All right, now across the field to Anthony Herron.
Thanks, Lewis, and I'm joined by Southern head coach Stump Mitchell. Stump, this is your second time experiencing the pageantry of the Bayou Classic. What was your message to the team about handling the environment?
Last game of the season, but we still have the opportunity to end in a four-way tie for first, and that's coming a long ways from where we were last year.
And you rotated quarterbacks a lot throughout the season, but J.P. Douglas had a bit of a coming-out party against Alabama State in that upset. What's made him so effective?
Well, he's a smart kid. Dre Joseph sustained a concussion. It allowed J.P. Douglas to go in and do it. He's a smart kid, and he wants to get it done.
Thanks a lot. Good luck today, Coach. Thanks. Paul, we've got more storylines today than we know what to do with. Let's have some fun, guys.
Yes, we do, Anthony. Thank you very much. And Southern will get the ball first, so we're going to get a real early look here, Sean King, at J.P. Douglas, the man that Anthony and Stump were just talking about.
And we talked so much in the open about Doug's son, DJ, who's the Grambling starting quarterback. Southern has a freshman starting today. Also, J.P. Douglas got a chance to talk to him this week, and he's just as excited for this opportunity today.
And back deep for Southern, Terrell Alex, number 21, and also number 7 starting quarterback, Virgil Williams, 38th annual Bayou Classic underway. This is Virgil Williams turning the corner around the 20. And goes down before he reaches the 30-yard line. That's a gain or a return of 28 yards. J.P. Douglas, freshman out of Roswell, Georgia, getting the start. Spending time with him earlier here, Sean, as we have an injured Tiger on the field at the 13-yard line. But spending time with him earlier, Sean, two things jumped out to me. Number one, he looks like he's 14. And then number two, for a freshman, he's got a real maturity and sense of calm about it, too.
He does. He acts almost like an old man. You talk to him, and he's very composed. He's very mature, really understands what they're trying to get done offensively here at Southern. Stump Mitchell has a West Coast style of offense. He said his favorite throw is the five-step speed out. I'm excited to see him get an opportunity to make that pass this season.
And the injured Tiger down in the field is E.J. Terry, a linebacker out of Stockbridge, Georgia. You see him right there on the 16-yard line go down. Doug Williams, perfect record as a quarterback against Southern. 1, 2, 3, 4 wins, 35-5 all time as Grambling's starting quarterback, but only one win as a coach, 1-5. Keep in mind, this is his second stint as the Grambling head coach. He was the man to succeed Eddie Robinson back in 1998. Only one win. E.J. Terry still injured on the field. Doug Williams checking out his injured Tiger. We'll take a break. And the first series of the game on the other side of this break. Stump Mitchell, year two as the Southern head coach. 9 very good seasons as a running back with the St. Louis Cardinals. Excellent return man, receiving threat out of the backfield now in his second season, leading Southern. And his quarterback this afternoon in the Bayou Classic, J.P. Douglas, the freshman from Roswell, Georgia. Starting tailback is Sylvester Nzekwe, right up the middle for a gain of 3. Jamarcus Savage there for that Tiger defense. Starting lineup for the Southern offense up front. Little added pressure to all these guys up front as they are protecting a true freshman quarterback. And J.P. Douglas and LaQuinton Evans, number 82. His teammates call him Smoke. He is the leading receiver for this Jaguar offense. Second down, seven now from the 31-yard line. And Zeke Way remains the tailback. J.P. Douglas rolling to his right, his first passing attempt of this afternoon. Looking for Charles Hawkins, and I left that one off the field. It'll bring up third down, seven. Grambling Tigers defense up front. Number 99, Jamarcus Savage, leads the team in sacks with six. In the middle, Mr. Everything is Cliff Exama. For the second season in a row, number 50 leads the Southwest Athletic Conference in tackles. And in the back end, Naquan Smith, three interceptions that tops the Tiger D.
And Paul, I really want to see you mention that Grambling front. 17 tackles between those four starters. How much pressure can they put on this young quarterback from Southern?
J.P. Douglas now facing third down and seven. Tigers bring the linebacker blitz with a pocket and time. The freshman stands and fires for a Southern first down.
I watched J.P. Douglas in warm-ups. Very fundamentally sound player. I love the way he keeps his feet underneath him. Was very accurate throwing the football in warm-ups. Was anxious to see how it looked once the live action started. Good job right there. Quick decision. Very accurate throw.
LaQuinton Evans, again, his number one receiver coming into this game with 42. Now has 43 receptions this season. And Southern has its first down of the afternoon. And Zeke Way cutting it back, looking for open room there in that Tiger defense stout, only a gain of two. Southern offense, as J.P. Douglas told me earlier this morning, pass first. He told me that a couple times, so I went and checked the numbers, Sean, and 57% pass, 43% run. Even though he's a freshman, they'll look to let him throw more than they will run the ball this afternoon. Second down, eight, couple of wide receivers to his left, a tight end and a wide out to his right. This is Nzikwe. Out to the midfield stripe. Jaguar gain of seven.
You know, J.P. is a very interesting young man. Even though he's a freshman, he is mature beyond his age. Coming into Southern, he entered with 21 college credit hours already to his name. When he finishes at the end of the second semester, he'll have 52 credit hours after his first year at Southern. Really understands what it is to be a student athlete. Mentioned that he wants to be a cardiologist. Has a lot of family here today. Really wanted to play well.
A pre-med major in biology. Thought about going to the Ivy League. Settled on Southern, now starting in his first season. This is third down and three, and down goes Douglas. We told you about Cliff Exama leading the Southwestern Athletic Conference in tackles. That is a sack for a loss of seven.
Cliff Exama was itching at the bit to be a part of this game. Was not able to play last year due to injury. Has 14 tackles for a loss coming into this game. Really makes a lot of plays behind the line of scrimmage. Dynamic, aggressive player at linebacker for Grambling.
Southwestern Athletic Conference Player of the Week in his last game. 18 tackles, 2.5 tackles for loss. Picking up right where he left off. On the punt for Southern, Manuel Canto also acts as the kicker for the Jaguars. Off the side of his foot, rolls out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Tiger defense strong right away. We'll see if the offense can follow suit.
State Farm, this is Jessica.
Hey, Jessica. Jerry Newman with a policy question.
Jerry, how are you doing?
Fine. I just got a little fender bender.
Oh, Jerry, I'm...
The State Farm Bayou Classic is brought to you by the United States Marine Corps. The few, the proud, the Marines. And by State Farm, proud title sponsor of the Bayou Classic. Paul Burmeister, Sean King, Lewis Johnson, Anthony Heron back in New Orleans, a town that Sean knows very well. 4 years as a quarterback at Tulane. At quarterback right now is DJ Williams, the freshman for the Tigers, giving right away to the top tailback. For Grambling, Dorrance Roberts for a gain of seven. DJ Williams coming off a big performance last week. 14 out of 19, three touchdowns and a come from behind win over Texas Southern. started the first four games, sat on the bench to watch Frank Rivers play, and now back as the starting quarterback for his father, Doug Williams. Gives inside once again to Dorrance Roberts, running hard. Good enough for a Grambling first down and pick up a four. Up front for the Tigers, a very balanced offense coming into this one, 60% run, 40% pass. And at the skill position, Mario Lewis, by far and away the number one receiving threat. 967 receiving yards. He leads the Southwestern Athletic Conference in yards per catch at 21.5. Dorrance Roberts, three plays, three carries by Roberts. On first and 10, he gets three.
And I definitely think the two best players on the field today are both wide receivers, Mario Lewis and Smoke Evans from Southern. Definitely guys I think have the potential to play at the next level.
And Mario Lewis had over 200 yards receiving in that last game. The next best receiver, Sean, only has 208 receiving yards. So he is the man. Over 53% of the receiving yards on this team hauled in by Mario Lewis. Williams with a play fake and rush to get that one off. Avoids disaster, avoids the sack and the turnover, and it'll be third down and 7.
Jamie Payton is a transfer linebacker for Southern. Actually came over from Lambeth University. Leads the team in tackles with 78. He's a guy that Stump Mitchell raved about this week. Actually talked to Jamie yesterday. He said he idolizes Ray Lewis. He loves his intensity, his love for the game, and the passion with which he plays and tries to emulate it in his own performance.
Third down and 7. DJ Williams undoubtedly will be looking for number one, Mario Lewis. Jaguars bring four and get there with four. Football comes out. Grambling State does recover. Jaguar defense with the sack and the forced fumble. That's Kidi Inabulele providing the pressure and knocking the ball loose.
That's the three technique, Paul, the big defensive tackle. That's what you have to do, especially against a young quarterback. They want to show DJ Williams different coverages. So if you can get pressure with your down lineman, that gives the defense every advantage to be able to take advantage of that Grambling offense. They felt they had a really good feel for this game plan coming in.
Fabian Carter back to punt. Lefty gets it off. Virgil Williams, number 7, fair catch. In his own 23-yard line. Both defenses coming out strong. Stump Mitchell, J.P. Douglas will get their second crack at the Tigers after this.
Hey! Can Heather come out and play?
I'm almost ready. I'll be right there.
What does that mean, play?
You know, a little this, a little that.
Girls, not out.
Bit of entertainment.
Thirty-eighth annual State Farm Bayou Classic here at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in New Orleans. 9-12 left in the first quarter. No score. Freshman quarterback J.P. Douglas leading the way for the Jaguars and doing so now in an empty backfield. Douglas stepping and firing with accuracy. Finding Charles Hawkins for a Jaguar first down and a gain of 15.
Good job by JP of getting to his second option. LaQuentin Evans is actually the guy he wanted to throw the football to. He was not available. Good job of getting to Charles Hawkins, which is something that you don't see a lot with young quarterbacks. A lot of them are very talented. They have the skill sets, but it's the decision making that's inconsistent. So far, great job by JP Douglas.
He's been efficient in his last three outings. 6 touchdowns with only 1 interception and off to a 2-for-3 start this afternoon. Drop play to Ezekiel and going nowhere. The Grambling State defense. Tackle in the backfield made by Cliff Exama. Loss of 3. The Stump Mitchell, the head coach. 9 years as a running back with the St. Louis and Arizona Cardinals. Franchise all-time leader in total yards. Went to Morgan State as the head coach for a short stint. Then it was off to the National Football League to coach running backs in Seattle. Then went with Jim Zorn to Washington. 1 season there, and then accepted the head coaching job last January here at Southern. This is season number 2.
And that's a great name for an NFL running back. Stump Mitchell just sounds like he should play running back.
Second down, 13. once again, J.P. Douglas. Jamarcus Savage, the team leader in sacks, now has 7 on the season. That is also a loss of 7 yards.
Savage was an all-conference performer last season. Actually got off to a slow start this year for the Grambling defensive line, but you can see he is bringing his A game so far in today's ball game.
Second possession for Southern, and already Grambling defense with 2 sacks on the first series. Cliff Exama got in there, and now Jamarcus Savage with a loss of 7.
And this could be a reoccurring theme today, Paul. Southern actually starts 2 freshmen on that line. Right then you saw Dwayne Houston, that right tackle, get beat by Jamarcus Savage.
Penalty markers come in now on 3rd down and 20.
Delay of game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still 3rd down.
One thing to keep an eye on throughout the game today, guys, is the motion from the Southern offense. This coaching staff felt like when Grambling was going to bring additional pressure, the motion they used would allow J.P. Douglas an opportunity to dissect that defense for just a few extra moments. That was something that Scott Mitchell told us throughout the week. He wants them to be ahead of the clock by the time they get to the line of scrimmage, so he's got a chance to survey the D.
And, Sean, you see 3rd down and long situations handled differently. On 3rd and 25 with a freshman quarterback, maybe just an easy completion. That is if he can come up with a football, avoiding pressure in the pocket and finally going down. Cliff Exama there. Loss of 1, and I was going to ask you if you try and go for an easy completion. I guess that time you just say, we're thankful we have the football and we'll punt it away.
Yeah, this could have ended up really bad for Southern, but JP does a good job of gaining possession of the football, not forcing it, not throwing an interception, understanding this play has broken down. Let the punt team come on. The defense did a good job on the first series. We'll get another opportunity.
One of those things that goes unnoticed. He didn't make a bad play worse. As a young quarterback, you might see some guys try to still go for the big play on a broken situation like that.
Manuel Canto back to punt for the 2nd time this afternoon. And back deep for Grambling State, David Stuckman. 8 returns, impressive average of 22.2 yards. Not going to get a chance there. Jaguars get a friendly bounce. Punt of 42 yards. Doug Williams' offense back on the field after this.
Aaron, you're all set.
Great.
That is Southern true freshman quarterback J.P. Douglas, and yes, he is a freshman in college, Sean. 0-for-2 on the 2 possessions, the 2nd possession of Grambling State, the 1st carry by Dorrance Roberts for a gain of 2. And this is an offense now under Doug Williams for the first season. Doug back in his 2nd stint as the head coach at his alma mater. Still kind of in transition, Sean King, from a very run-heavy offense led by Ron Bradway here recently to more of a pass-first this year.
Well, they graduated Frank Bourne, who's one of the more decorated rushers in the history of the Southwestern Athletic Conference, so he knew he had to fill that void. Adding the fact they have a young quarterback, he said they've been very conservative this year with their play calling.
And actually run the ball more than they've passed, and this is an excellent strike from DJ Williams to Van Phillips. Gain of 24, putting it right on the money.
And as a young quarterback, I played as a freshman. One of the things I wanted was give me a balanced look, let me take a 3-step drop, throw a slant, something, get the ball out of my hands quickly. Good throw by DJ Williams.
Hurry up offense for the Tigers now into Jaguar territory. Back to the ground, back to Dorrance Roberts running hard. Gain of 9.
This is something that you see throughout college football. Offensives have all adapted an ability to change paces and speeds with which they run that offense during the game.
No huddle offense. Roberts remains the lone running back as the Jaguars come with the blitz and gets a Roberts before he can reach the line of scrimmage. That's Jamie Payton, the top tackler for the Jaguar D. Loss of 3.
Jamie Payton is a very interesting story. I mentioned earlier, he's a transfer from Lambeth University. They actually did away with their athletic programs because of a lack of finances. The wide receiver coach here, Coach Baez, recommended Stump Mitchell look at some tape of a linebacker we had, and that's how he ended up at Southern.
Loss of 3 brings up 3rd down and 4. Again, it's Dorrance Roberts, the running back to the left. Jaguars come again with the blitz. Penalty marker down, and stepping up is DJ Williams, firing for the touchdown. Desmond Spivey on the receiving end. We'll see if the play stands.
Offense. Two men moving at the same time. 84 never got set prior to the snap. 5-yard penalty. Replay. Third down.
And this is going to come back, but you see why there's so much excitement in Grambling, Louisiana. From a skill set standpoint, DJ Williams has all the characteristics and attributes of really good quarterbacks. He's huge. I hadn't seen him since he played high school down in Tampa, at Tampa Catholic. He stands 6'5". He needs to gain a little weight, but he's athletic. He can make all the throws. All he lacks is experience.
Nice job of recognizing that he was going to run, stepping up and firing. Now it's third down and 9. Thought about keeping it, now just swings it out of the backfield to Kenneth Batiste. Jaguar defense not having that. Gain of 4, and it'll be fourth down and 5.
Kind of a defensive battle early in this ball game. Both offenses kind of feeling their way around a little bit, trying to find a comfort zone.
Stump Mitchell, former special teams star for the St. Louis Cardinals. Wondering what type of special teams play we're going to have here. It's going to be an attempted field goal from 52 yards out. 53 yards out. Zoltan Riazzo trying to draw that one back in. Yes, he does. And the Tigers have 3 points. He was 5 for 6 from 40 to 49 yards, but hadn't connected from over 50 until just now. 53 yards out. Grambling has 3 points and a 3-point lead in the 38th annual State Farm Bayou Classic.
We lift our glasses as they explode.
Yo, Pops, I just want to celebrate a union of crazy technology and crazy cool.
He's not my side of the family.
I'm talking about the Ford Explorer. You got to see it.
Moments ago, Zoltan Riazzo, 53-yard field goal, and the Tigers lead the Jaguars by 3, 2:55 left here in the Mercedes-Benz Superdome first quarter. Offense, defense, just getting this thing felt out here as we get started. Defense been on top so far. And we're about to see these Southern Jaguars with their third possession on offense. Virgil Williams. With a lane, cuts back, and here comes the speed. Virgil Williams takes it back into Tiger territory, a return of 65 yards. We do have a penalty marker on the 40-yard line. Referee today is Roderick Holloway.
Personal foul, 58 on the receiving team, 15 yards. Southern will retain possession of the ball, first down.
Number 58 is Corey Roy, a linebacker out of Hawaii.
Unfortunate turn of events there. I want you to see Wade Julian right here. Sometimes you're the hammer and sometimes you're the nail. That block right there sprung Virgil into what turned into a huge kickoff return for Southern.
And Sean, this sideline down here for Southern really came alive as Virgil Williams broke through. He's explosive in the kick return game. Williams also their best cover corner. You're going to see them try to match him up with Mario Lewis.
Sylvester and Zeke Way looking to get that run game going. The rush offense coming into this game last in the Southwestern Athletic Conference, only 72 yards per game, and that is no gain on first down.
Their starting tailback, Sylvester Nzikwe, is actually a walk-on. He is playing for a scholarship. This is his second year on the Southern Ball Club. Stump Mitchell said that he's been impressed with the young man this year, and it looks like he will be a scholarship athlete next year at Southern.
Went over 100 yards rushing twice in October against Prairie View A&M and also Alcorn State. He is the tailback on second down 10. J.P. Douglas firing, and the ball is tipped. falls harmlessly incomplete. Nice job of defense there by Cedric Goins for the Tigers.
JP said this is his favorite throw, that five-step speed out. Well, what happens if you don't have anything to control the underneath coverage? Sometimes that flat defender can float and get underneath that deep out, and that's what happened in that case.
Third down and 10. JP telling me prior to the game, I'm glad I'm from Georgia. I don't know all the history and rivalry of this. It just would have made me more nervous this week anyway. Tough situation here, third down and 10. Five-step, stepping up and firing into coverage and falling incomplete. Two incompletions in a row, and it'll be fourth and 10.
Great relationship there from Grambling between the pass rush and the coverage. Jamarcus Savage, who had the sack on a previous series, they kept it back in the backfield to chip on him. Still was able to make the quarterback just nervous enough, but pass was incomplete.
Back to punt, Manuel Canto. David Stuckman back to receive for the Tigers. Averaging over 22 yards per return on 8 returns this season. Lifts it high and calling for the fair catch is Stuckman on his own 18-yard line. Grambling defense pitching a shutout so far. The Tigers lead by 3.
Timeout.
Hi, John.
I was raised in this house, the youngest of 3.
After the legendary, the late Eddie Robinson, no name more synonymous with Grambling football success. And the head coach, Doug Williams, redshirted in 1973, became the starter 5 games in his freshman year. Went 35-5 from there. He could really fire it and fired it very well in the National Football League as well. MVP of the Redskins Super Bowl victory over the Broncos in San Diego. Then became a coach. He succeeded Eddie Robinson in 1998, stayed till 2003, and now he's back in his first year in his second stint. And let's kick it down to Lewis Johnson.
All right, Paul, well, we talked to DJ earlier this week about his preparation for the Bayou Classic, and he admitted that he has not been able to sleep very well. He said he's been coming to the Classic since he was 5 years old, has great memories of that, but hope that he'd be able to settle down. Now, on the sideline, he's looked pretty calm. His dad and his son have had pretty matter-of-fact conversations. But when you ask him about pressure, he says he has to embrace the pressure. Says since he's a youngster, knew that he would have to live up to Doug Williams' standard. The dad said even when he played basketball, guys, everyone looked up to him differently because he's Doug Williams' son.
All right, Lewis, and Doug has said all week, hey, at home, I'm dad. When we're at the football complex, call me coach. DJ Williams handing off to Dorrance Roberts, skipping around the outside, breaking tackles and picking up a Grambling first down. Like his quickness and also his vision there. Shauna, he's been the spark here for this Tiger offense so far. That's a gain of 9.
He has. He very elusive type of running back. Came into this game averaging 5.9 yards per carry. To get back to DJ, I got an opportunity because when I lived down in Tampa, Doug was a part of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers organization, you know, for the last couple of years. He is a great kid, you know, just one of those guys that's really fun to be around. You really root for him and you pull for him. Just really interesting and fascinating to watch him grow up under the shadow of his father.
Out of the shotgun, handing off to Dorrance Roberts on 1st and 10, picking up 4 yards. And at Tampa Catholic, he actually sat behind Christian Green, a quarterback who would eventually play at Florida State, had to play wide receiver just to get on the field.
I know, it's very interesting. Christian Green is now a wide receiver at Florida State. Well, that was a very good high school football team he played on, but you never heard him complain. He always continued to work hard, and you knew once he got his opportunity that he'd take advantage of it.
Dorrance Roberts has been the focal point of the offense so far. 9 carries for 42 yards, and this will be the final play of the first quarter. This is Kenneth Batiste providing Roberts a blow and providing another first down for that Tiger offense as he gets just into Jaguar territory, a gain of 12. That's the end of the first quarter with the score Grambling State 3 and Southern 0. We'll return to the State Farm Bayou Classic after these messages from your local NBC stations. first quarter of the 38th annual State Farm Bayou Classic, all about defense and a little bit of special teams. Zoltan Riazzo, 53-yard field goal, and the Tigers lead 3-0. This will be the first play of the second quarter with DJ Williams, the freshman quarterback and son of Doug Williams, leading the way, and a penalty marker down.
Prior to the snap, false guard, 77 offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Two freshman quarterbacks on the field today, Sean, and DJ Williams has had something that his counterpart, PJ Douglas, has not, and that's a solid running game to complement the passing game.
Grambling is very balanced. You know, Doug understands that one of the ways to take some of the pressure off of a young quarterback is to have the ability to run the football. They've committed to it, and surprisingly, they've been good at it.
We've yet to see a pass completed to number one Mario Lewis, who leads the Southwestern Athletic Conference in receiving touchdowns and also yards per catch. To the air, there's Lewis, and there is the Jaguar defense led by Jamie Payton. Tried to work that little slip screen, and the senior linebacker from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, said, not right now.
Paul, there are two great linebackers playing in this football game, and one of them is Jamie Payton. He has been an unbelievable presence on this Southern defense. Again, it's his first year here. He leads the team in tackles with 78, 8 tackles for losses. Stump Mitchell rants and raves about his leadership and how he has really elevated the play of this entire defensive unit. You see right here, he diagrams that little jailbreak screen that Grambling was trying to run and just disrupts everything with a vicious hit.
The defensive coordinator. Sorry, Paul, the defensive coordinator, O'Neal Gilbert, who really felt like he had a bead on when they wanted to run that particular play. And Jamie Payton, he really brought the funk on that one.
Second down, 15. Kenneth Batiste, number 5, in a tailback to Williams' left. Batiste with the football and with room to run, puts the ball on the ground, and the Jaguars had it for a second. Did they have it long enough to maintain possession? Southern football. Virgil Williams comes up with the Kenneth Batiste fumble.
Batiste actually makes a nice cut and just simply drops the football. Doesn't look like he was contacted by any defender from Southern. The football just comes out of his hand.
And that's Virgil Williams, the defensive back, falling on it. First down and 10. First break for the Southern Jaguars. They begin from their own 40. Ezekwe looking to get around the right side. Cliff Exama there to shove him right back at the line of scrimmage after a gain of 1. Take another look at the fumble there. Jared Dietrich, number 57, knocking that one loose.
A good call there from the officials afterwards. Wasn't sure if Virgil Williams actually had the football possessed yet before that second recovery that we saw, but he was down by contact, as we see.
Second down, 8 now for the freshman J.P. Douglas. Whistles blow.
Prior to the snap, false guard, 72 offense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
And Sean, the Jaguars' failure to really get this running game going to make life easier for the freshman quarterback, J.P. Douglas. Not a huge surprise coming into this game for Stump Mitchell, who played 9 seasons at a high level as an NFL running back with the St. Louis and Arizona Cardinals. Got to be disappointing that his running game right now dead last in the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
It's been a work in progress. They're playing some young players on that offensive line, still have not found a cohesive unit. So trying to get that 5 together that he thinks works the best, but also I think you have to resort to your short passing game a little bit when you're not having a lot of success running the football. Throw those slants, throw those hitches.
Prior to the snap, false start, 76 offense, 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
One of the aspects of the West Coast offense that's I think Gibson an advantage when you don't have a great running game is there's so much three-step throw involved in it that you can kind of supplement some aspects of your rushing attack with that short passing game.
And unlike his counterpart DJ Williams, he's got some pretty nice balance in terms of production from his wide receivers. DJ Williams only has one with more than 12 catches. That's Mario Lewis. And JP Douglas has five wide receivers with 20 or more catches. Gonna need him now on second down and 18. Stepping up with a four-man rush. The Tigers get there. Jamarcus Savage with what would be his second sack of the afternoon. We do have a penalty marker down.
Holding 74 offense. That penalty decline brings up third down.
And this has to be frustrating for Southern coach Stump Mitchell. One of the things that he talked about coming into the game was he has not found consistency in his offensive unit. They have made a lot of mistakes. They've had a lot of turnovers. You get the big turnover by your defense. You have some momentum. You get two false starts and a holding call in three consecutive plays.
Every time the Jaguar offensive line has come to the sideline after a series, the offensive staff has sat them all down and talked about communication of the blitz.
Ezekway on third down and 26. Going for a loss of two, Cliff Exama. Once again, the conference's leading tackler is there behind the line of scrimmage. Jaguars offense now, and it's only 12:35 left in the second quarter. Nine plays already for no gain or less.
And I've talked about the impact that Jamie Payton has had. Cliff Exama has had the same impact for that Grambling defense. When I look at linebackers, some guys have a lot of tackles, but they don't make a lot of plays. Cliff Exam is a guy that not only has a lot of tackles, but he makes plays. He makes tackles behind the line of scrimmage. He gets interceptions. He gets sacks. He makes a difference on that Grambling defense.
Manuel Canto, busy afternoon. David Stuckman, fair catch on the 45-yard line. With his Tigers leading by three, Doug Williams will get another look at his son, DJ Williams, right after this break.
Today is going to be a good day. America's fastest growing broadband company is here. We're CenturyLink, and we're...
The State Farm Bayou Classic is brought to you by Cheez-It, because at Cheez-It, real cheese matters. And by State Farm. Get to a better state. Texas Rangers manager Ron Washington is a football fan, also a New Orleans native, and he is on the sidelines with our Lewis Johnson.
During the festivities here of this Bayou Classic, Coach, your baseball career started right here in the Big Easy. What are your memories as you go back to John McDonough High School, 1970?
Well, my memories are just getting an opportunity to play, you know, in a city when I first went to senior high school, integration had just started, and it was an opportunity to get some exposure. And the little exposure that I was able to get, it helped me to arrive where I am today. And this is where I started, in the deep inner cities of New Orleans at Sampson Park and Desire Project, and just moved forward. And there's a lot of people along the way that had their hands on me that made all of this possible.
I noticed that a lot of people want to get their picture with you and talk, and you look like you're relaxed, but I'm imagining you're pretty busy right now. What's happening in the offseason?
Well, right now, you know, we're trying to see whatever we can do to strengthen our ball club, and it's been a very busy winter so far. I'm headed back to Texas here next week and, you know, make a few appearances, continue to see how many fans we can get to become Texas Rangers and fortify our club, and hopefully we can make another run.
All right, well, enjoy the rest of the afternoon, and we look forward to seeing you continue your work there in Texas.
Well, thank you so much.
All right, Coach, thank you. Well,
we just saw the reverse. Mario Lewis cut down by Michael Bell, and it'll be third down and six. Sean, go ahead.
I want my picture taken with Ron Washington.
I know you're a baseball fan down there in Tampa.
I am.
Following the Rays.
Two World Series and a bowl. Haven't been able to win it, but they've gotten there.
Heck of a two-year run for those Texas Rangers. Right now, the Grambling State Tigers. Third down and six. If they choose to run, the running back to DJ Williams' right is Doris Roberts. Jaguars bring four. Williams with time. And a completion down to the 37-yard line. Damian Jefferson for a gain of 13.
And DJ Williams is a freshman, but he plays a lot of poise. That was his third option on that play. Big third down conversion for Grambling.
First down and 10. Back to Dorrance Roberts, right back up the middle. Jaguar defense allowing only a gain of 2. And on that first down pickup there, the completion to Damian Jefferson, Sean, I said, DJ Williams with time. And I've not been able to say that about JP Douglas very often through a quarter and a half.
Grambling has a much more experienced offensive line unit, actually one of the strengths of their team, where Southern is trying to find a cohesive unit, playing some younger players. So that's what you would expect when you look at the experience level of both teams.
Second down, 7 now for the freshman DJ Williams. Jaguars bring Jamie Payton. Roberts shakes that tackle and picks up a Grambling first down. Linebacker Jamie Payton came on the blitz, had his hands on Roberts, but he eluded that tackle, picked up 8 yards and a Grambling first down.
Jamie Payton doesn't miss many tackles, does a good job of dissecting the play, runs through the gap. Dorrance Roberts, it's why he averages 5.9 yards per carry. Not a very violent, powerful runner, but he's very elusive. I would call him slippery. Finds a way to get out of tackles.
It's a good way of putting it for the Southwest Athletic Conference leader in yards per game at 105.5. First down at 10. Tigers on the move on the 27-yard line. Jaguars bring the blitz. It's picked up and firing to the end zone. Coming down with a touchdown is Mario Lewis. DJ Williams to Mario Lewis, his 15th touchdown reception this season.
They call him Super Mario, and this is why. You throw the football in his area. He's dynamic. He's athletic. He goes up, does a good job of high pointing the football. Touchdown, Grambling Tigers.
So many times anymore at the college and professional level, Sean, you see a quarterback just give a wide receiver a chance. He's not necessarily open, just gives him a chance to get it. Mario Lewis took advantage of that chance. Extra point up and in. 6 plays, 55 yards, and 7 points. The Tigers lead by 10. Mario Lewis has more touchdown receptions than any receiver in the Southwestern Athletic Conference. He has the first touchdown of this game, and Grambling leads by 10.
Yeah.
Mario Lewis, number 1, his first catch on this day. Good for a touchdown, 27 yards out from DJ Williams moments ago. Add that to a Zoltan Riazzo 53-yard field goal in the first quarter, and the Tigers leading the Jaguars by 10. Virgil Williams. And the Southern Jaguars ready to come back on offense.
And one of the things that I thought would be critical was, could Southern pass protect for their young quarterback, JP Douglas? Jamarcus Savage and Antonio Leonard, the two ends from Grambling, have combined for 19 and a half sacks coming into this game. They've really taken advantage of these young tackles from Southern and given freshman quarterback JP Douglas no time to throw the football. Also been dynamic in the running game, getting penetration, being disruptive in that Southern backfield.
I've been struck by the variety of the blitz packages and the effectiveness of the edge rushes. JP Douglas seeing ghosts so far.
To the air on a 5-step drop, stepping up, firing over the middle. LaQuint Nevins with the catch and the run for a Jaguar first down.
And this
Douglas
is
to Evans for 12.
And this is what I wanted to see from LaQuint and Smoke Evans, Paul. He has a haircut that's very unique today. He actually has the letters R-A-C boy cut into his head, Rack Boy. He said it means run after catch. He came into this game as a senior, last opportunity. He said, if JP gets me the football, I will make some exciting and explosive things happen after I get it.
Came to Southern as a walk-on. Well, didn't even walk on right away. Was playing intramural football. He was a high school basketball player. Coaches found him on the intramural field, and here he is now as the leading receiver. JP Douglas with pressure in his face. And underthrowing Jared Green, who found himself wide open in that Tiger secondary.
from down here at field level, really struck by how tentative J.P. Douglas starting to look a bit right now. Sean, curious for your take on it as a quarterback, where you see a receiver running wide open there in the seam, the short arm of pass like that, he's got a nice quick release, mechanically sound, but does look like he's getting tentative at this point.
Just like a defender, blame the quarterback. It's very difficult, Anthony, to throw the football when Aaron Hall, your left guard, is right in front of you. You can't step through the throw. Boy, those defenders like to point fingers at the quarterback.
I can say the quarterback up here is pointing fingers at the O-line.
Very true.
And he wanted that one caught, put it right on Charles Hawkins, couldn't come down with it. And it'll be third down. Southern offense so far, 19 total plays, 11, Sean, no yards or less. That's also to go along with three sacks the Tiger defense already come up with. And Stump Mitchell, his team with the big goose egg on the board right now and facing a third down and 10.
And we've mentioned his name a lot today, but the guy that broke up the previous pass was Cliff Exama. I mean, he's been everywhere, in the backfield, in pass coverage, very dynamic linebacker for that Grambling D.
Coming off a performance where he had 18 tackles and 2.5 tackles for loss in the last game. There's a pocket. There's also a flag down. Good piece of defense there by the Grambling State defense. David Stuckman knocking that one away.
Number three offense, that penalty decline, brings up fourth down.
Tough series for Charles Hawkins. Drop pass. Caused a penalty. That penalty declined. Stump Mitchell talking to J.P. Douglas as the punt team takes the field once again for the Southern Jaguars. David Stuckman back to receive just moments after he knocked away the pass. This is the fifth punt of the afternoon already for Manuel Canto. Lifts it high, fair catch. Hits Stuckman in the face after the bounce. The Southern Jaguars have recovered. David Stuckman wanted the fair catch, allowed the ball to bounce, came right up and hit him in the face mask. And it's recovered by Roy Corey.
You know, Paul, it almost looks as though he lost the football in the lights. If you can see, it doesn't really seem to do a good job of being able to get under the football. Big turnover for this Southern football team that's trying to find a spark, trying to get something going. You know, very interesting in some of the play calling by Ricky Diggs, who's the offensive coordinator here at Southern. They've been really aggressive throwing the football. Might want to get to some of that three-step throw, get the football out of JP's hands a little quicker.
Southern offense in its best position so far in the Grambling 28. Douglas stepping and firing. First down, Jaguars. That's a gain of 15 to Michael Berry.
That's how you want to see a young quarterback throw the football. Play action, hit your back leg, and get the football out of your hands. Threw a strike right there.
See how he waited for him to open up there, Sean? Wasn't going there right away, but came back at just the right time.
Got to his second option, and we've talked a lot today about Smoke Evans, but Mike Berry, who made that catch, has been just as dynamic and productive in his own right, coming to the football game, averaging 13 yards a catch and 6 touchdowns on the season.
Number 2 wide receiver for this team, 35 receptions, as Sean mentioned. Just behind LaQuinton Evans. First down and 10 now from the 13. Looks left and comes back to the right. Touchdown of Jaguars. Lee Doss. J.P. Douglas all of a sudden finding success against Doug Williams' Tigers.
A lot of composure showed by the freshman quarterback. Still not really a clean pocket. But if you see, he gets the opportunity on that throw to step through on his throw. Very accurate. Makes the correct decision. Touchdown, Southern.
The decisiveness of it, Sean, is what makes the biggest difference to me. So decisive on those last couple of snaps.
Manuel Canto, after 5 punts, has his first extra point blocked. Tigers special teams stepping up to make a play at the end of this drive to block the extra point, and the score remains at 10-6. David Stuckman fumbled the punt. Muffed the punt that allowed Southern to take over on the Tiger 28. J.P. Douglas cashes in with a strike to Lee Doss. Jaguars on the board. It's 10-6.
Aaron.
NBC.
J.P. Douglas fires a touchdown to Lee Doss. Missed extra point, and it's 10-6. For more on that missed extra point, we go down the sidelines, check in with Anthony Herron.
How many times when you talk to a head coach about the biggest difference from one season to the next, does he say it's the kicker? Stump Mitchell has told us so many times throughout the week that the kicking game has been the biggest disappointment for Southern this season. Yet another missed extra point here. There was a point in the Southern season where they lost four games, and out of those four games, only by a total of 13 points. Missed kicks, missed extra points, the biggest difference in those contests.
David Stuckman on the return just moments after his mistake led to the first Southern touchdown of the game. That's a return of 25 to Doug Williams, former player. He remembers what it's like to make a mistake. Instead of yelling at David Stuckman on the sideline after he muffed the punt and Southern took over on the 28, put your arm around him. Tell him it's all right. A lot more plays left in this game. I like to see that, Sean.
Well, Doug understands that the young man is out there, he's trying hard. You know, there's a human aspect to this sport that you're going to have some mistakes made. He knows that he needs him. He can be an important component of their special teams. Wants him to know, okay, that play's done with. Let's move forward.
See how the Tigers respond to the Jaguars' first touchdown. They put it on the ground to Dorrance Roberts. And putting him on the ground is Jamie Payton.
Before this broadcast is over, Paul, you're going to buy into what I'm telling you about this linebacker, Jamie Payton.
I think I believe you.
For the Southern defense. Gilbert O'Neill, the linebacker coach, defensive coordinator here at Southern, rants and raves about the young man. He thinks he has NFL type of ability. He loves his instincts. He said he makes plays.
Knows all about Southern football, growing up in Baton Rouge, home of the Southern Jaguars. Second down, 9. Back to the ground. More Dorrance Roberts and more Jamie Payton. Putting on a clinic from the linebacker spot behind the line of scrimmage. That's a loss of 1.
What I love about the way that O'Neal Gilbert describes this linebacking core, he says they played the game with bad intentions. Grambling had some success running the football in this Bayou Classic matchup last season. They thought they were going to come out and try to establish the ground game again. But this front seven from Southern, they appear ready.
Coming into this game, Cliff Exama from Grambling State, the more heralded linebacker. But Jamie Payton, and Exama has had a nice game. Jamie Payton, the most aggressive, active linebacker on the field so far. This is 3rd down and 10. The Jaguars rush 4. Williams with time sees nothing he likes and just keeps it himself. Right at the first down marker. Might want to tuck that ball in a little more there, Sean, but a nice run anyway. Going to be about half a yard short of a Grambling first down, a gain of 9.
You know, that's a decision as a quarterback that you never want to be faced with. A yard from the first down marker, 2 defenders in front of you. It's just not a good spot for a quarterback.
We've been learning about the Sean King School of Quarterbacking all season. I think that book would say go ahead and slide.
Yeah,
I understand.
But conversely, as a defender, you love that scenario, Sean.
Defender's eyes light up as soon as they see that quarterback leave the pocket. Going for it now on 4th down and less than 1. Grambling 3 out of 5 in converting the situation so far this season. Dorrance Roberts picking his way up to the line of scrimmage. Stump Mitchell says no, he doesn't have it. It's going to be close. Southern defense after the Southern offense scored for the first time on this day. Trying to respond with a big stop on 4th and less than 1.
Behind the line, Judge, guys, from down here at field level. Doesn't look like he has it to me.
Jaguar defense holds by an inch. Stump Mitchell, the former running back. Way to go, D. Just after the offense scored, Jaguar defense stepping up huge. And for the 2nd possession in a row, Southern will begin in Grambling territory. Did they reverse that call?
They did, Paul. Indecision on the part of the officiating crew initially, but they did. The referee came in and signaled in the opposite direction. First down, Grambling.
Good eye, Anthony. He was watching a different referee. First down, it's at Tigers. Dorrance Roberts darting up the middle. Jamie Payton again with a tackle. Pick up a three.
And this is very close. Grambling decided to go for it. I've never been a fan of running a counter type of a play on fourth and short. Really like to get going. You see those linemen are moving. They can get pushed back into the backfield. Dorrance Roberts.
And that was all going to come down to Mark.
It's razor close right there, but.
Stump Mitchell thought he had the football. Now his defense back out there. Jamie Payton with a tackle, and it's now second down eight. Again, it's Dorrance Roberts. Again, making first contact is Payton. This time he has some Jaguar defenders there to help him out. And that's a gain of two. You see right away that Doug Williams, with his son and freshman quarterback leading the way, leaning on the run game heavily to lighten that load on DJ.
Southern linebacker Jamie Payton's making it very difficult. Now, almost to the point, if I'm Doug, I may have to bring a fullback in and just assign him to 56. Anytime we run the football, you find 56, make sure he doesn't make the tackle.
Dorrance Roberts already with 17 carries this afternoon. That pocket was there for a while. The football is out. Do the Jaguars have it? Southern football. Thought they had a stop on fourth down. Couple of plays later, they caused a turnover. Third turnover of the game.
And Paul, you just mentioned ball security when DJ scrambled out of the pocket a couple plays before that. Trying to extend the play, trying to move around the pocket, has that football in a non-secure location. Turnover, Southern. It's the momentum shifting here in Louisiana. 10-6 Grambling lead as Southern gains possession of the football.
The 38th annual Bayou Classic marks the 16-year anniversary of State Farm's title sponsorship. Hundreds of volunteers from State Farm and Kaboom joined forces yesterday to build a brand new playground for Andrew H. Wilson Charter School right here in New Orleans. This year's playground marks the sixth built by State Farm and Kaboom since Hurricane Katrina devastated the area. Also yesterday at the school, State Farm conducted its Neighborhood of Knowledge program. It not only educates teen drivers, but also their parents. The program assists in educating teens about driving independently, avoiding hazards, and overall driving safety techniques. 50-yard line, not a bad place to start for Southern. One series after scoring its first touchdown. 3:47 and counting left in the first half. J.P. Douglas off the mark on first down. It'll be second down 10. Looking for Sylvester and Zeke way out of the backfield. Stump Mitchell's offense taking advantage of a Grambling State turnover on the last possession, ending in a J.P. Douglas to Lee Doss touchdown on a quick slant. Extra point no good, and it's 10-6. Douglas right now 5 out of 12, 67 yards. Southern Jaguars only with 63 total yards this afternoon. In deep, he has Jared Green with a step a little bit too far out in front, and it'll be 3rd and 10. And if Jared Green looks fast, he comes by that naturally. He's the son of Hall of Fame Washington Redskin cornerback and returner Daryl Green.
I still think this is a misread by JP. This football should go inside to his tight end, Mike Berry, but he decided to take a shot. And the one thing that I teach young quarterbacks is there's two ways you can guarantee that that fade route is not caught. You throw it out of bounds, you overthrow it. That opportunity there, it was there. He overthrew the football. Coaching point, give the wide receiver a chance to make the play.
3rd down 10 from the midfield stripe. Tigers come with 6. Force the early throw and the interception. Grené Foster. Pick it off the errant pass from Douglas. J.P. Douglas just rolling to the ground. Doug Williams, meanwhile, talking it over with his freshman quarterback and son, D.J. Williams. J.P. Douglas was a little late. Brené Foster said thank you very much. The Grambling Tigers with the football. The State Farm Bayou Classic gets you a better state, State Farm. Moments ago, after we saw J.P. Douglas with the interception, kind of gingerly off the field, went down to the ground and got back up. Number 10 is Dre Joseph. Has started at times this season, and he's warming up just in case J.P. can't go. This is Dorrance Roberts on the ground for the Grambling State offense.
And Dre Joseph came into the season as the starting quarterback here at Southern, so if there is an injury or something is wrong with J.P. Douglas, they do have two guys who have experience this season playing the position.
As for the Grambling State offense, Sean, as we are now inside 3 minutes until halftime. So far, 24 runs and only 6 passes. Can you keep that kind of mix now with the clock ticking as you try to get a next touchdown?
You know, I think Grambling's done a good job of calling the correct plays. They've just turned the football over.
They've had no answer for Jamie Payton, who is living behind the line of scrimmage. Throws him for a loss of one. That's throwing Dorrance Roberts for a loss of one. Anthony Heron, come on in.
Ball, I'm with Tevin Coleman. Big halftime show coming up here. He is the drum major, 3-year drum major here for Southern University. Can you give us any hints of what we're going to see here at the halftime?
Well, I really can't tell you. I just like to want y'all to stay in tune, and we're going to give you a nice little show. That's all I got to say.
A drum major with his game face on, Paul.
And providing a tease. Anthony, thank you very much. 2-12 and counting until halftime. DJ Williams stepping up and firing. And completes. Gain of 12. Nice job of standing in the pocket. We do have a penalty marker on the field.
And you're going to get rough in the passer. Very nice throw by DJ under duress.
First foul. Rough in the passer. Number 9 and 5. Defense. 15 yards added to the end of the run. First down.
You know, those are one of those aspects of playing the position, Paul, that you can't coach. You know, some guys have it, some guys don't. That ability to really stand in there under pressure and deliver the football. Really impressive throw by DJ Williams.
Completion stands to Terry McGill. Add on the 15 yards in Grambling State now. First and 10 on the 34-yard line. Already leading 10-6. DJ Williams with the inside give to Dorrance Roberts, picking his way. And that's a gain of 7. Let's go out on the sideline and check in with Lewis Johnson.
All right, Paul. Well, I have Yusuf Anderson, who is a second-year drum major. He's a senior, and you just got your tubas lined up out here, Yusuf. So tell me, how long have you been working on the program that everyone here in the Dome is about to see?
Well, for the program here that we're about to perform for halftime, we've been probably working on that for almost about 2 weeks now. This is one of our biggest games, so we spend a lot of time on it. We got practice at 3:30. From 3:30 to about 5, we'll practice music on the inside, and then we'll go outside around 5 to 6, break, then come back around 8, and then probably about from 8 to 10, and that's daily. On Fridays, then we start at 1:30, and we go all the way to the nightfall.
A long day. Finally, we talk about the pressure on the quarterbacks here on the field. Your quarterback in this thing, how much pressure is on you?
It's a lot of pressure. It's the same thing as a quarterback on the field. I mean, I have to ensure safety. I have to make sure that everybody's doing what they're supposed to do. I have to make sure that I have their back, make sure that I'm conducting them in the proper manner. It's a lot of pressure.
You're already conducted. I think you're ready. All right.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good luck out there, Yusuf.
Okay, appreciate it.
All right, Paul, I think he's ready.
I think so. Lewis, Yusuf, thank you. Third down and 4, 38 seconds left. And that's a late throw to the flat. Sean, we often see that going the other way. And I think DJ Williams lucky that that's just an incompletion.
I'm not going to let Yusuf off the hook. I heard him mention that it's the same pressure that the quarterbacks are under. Last time I checked, the drum major's not getting hit.
It's another page out of the Sean King School of Quarterback.
Sean, I was in the marching band in high school. Believe me, there is far more pressure than you might anticipate down here at field level.
I know it's pressure, but you know, it's not physical pressure. You're not getting hit.
Hey, Sean's not buying that argument there, Anthony. Zoltan Riazzo from 45 yards out. First quarter, he was true from 53 yards. He's 5 out of 6 this year. From 40 to 49 yards, that ball was tipped, locked at the line of scrimmage. The Southern Jaguars special team stepping up and making a play. 28 seconds left till halftime. Doug Williams Tigers lead by 6.
Aaron.
Coming up it's the U.S. Bank NBC Sports Halftime Report. Liam McHugh, Doug Flutie, and Roland Williams are all in our New York studio. They'll have college football scores and highlights, plus they'll take a look at tomorrow night's big game in Kansas City between the Steelers and the Chiefs. Plus, of course, you don't want to miss the Battle of the Bands. And this is Dre quarterbacking now for J.P. Douglas, left after the last series. He's experiencing the same thing, and that's no time in the pocket, but he keeps it himself out to the 41-yard line. Good for 12 and a Jaguar first down. We have an injured Jaguar as J.P. Douglas, the freshman quarterback, also injured and on the bench. Injured Southern Jaguar on the 18-yard line. Number 78 is Lee Almanza.
Good job by Dre Joseph of stepping up in the pocket. And when I asked JP directly, how's that relationship between him and Dre? A lot of times when you have two players competing for the same spot, you know, there can be a little friction there. But he said Dre has been extremely helpful. He said when Dre's in the game, he tried to support him and help him. So it's a good situation in the quarterback room at Southern.
And I would say a pretty good situation competence-wise for the head coach, your man you're watching right there, Stump Mitchell, to have a backup quarterback who was the starting quarterback until mid-October.
You know, having two guys that can play, it definitely is a relief if something happens to one guy, but I'm a firm believer that the quarterback position has to lead your football team. It's very difficult to lead when you're split in time in the football game.
Jaguars got on the board in the second quarter, taking advantage of a turnover on special teams. Lee Doss with the lone touchdown for Southern so far. Good to see Lee Almanza up and walking off the field. Senior offensive lineman out of Houston, Texas. There you see the baby face of J.P. Douglas.
And J.P. would have made the tackle on that interception, and he looks as though he may be a little dinged on that sideline. Maybe that's why he's not in the football game right now.
Dre Joseph in at quarterback, makes the draw. Stepping up and out to his right, finally firing and a little off the mark. 8 seconds remaining. We do have a penalty marker on the 33-yard line.
Holding, 72 offense. 10-yard penalty, previous spot enforcement. Replay, first down.
72 is Chris Brown, offensive lineman, a junior out of Cleveland, Ohio. Stump Mitchell, 9 seasons as a running back for the St. Louis and Arizona Cardinals, now second season as the head coach. Saw the hole there at the top of the screen. It's now 8 seconds remaining, first down and 20. Inside give to Ezekiel. Gain of 4, but the clocks hit zeros here at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Doug Williams, Tigers on top 10-6. We are at halftime here at the 38th annual State Farm Bayou Classic with the score, Grambling State 10 and Southern 6. Stay tuned for the U.S. Bank NBC Sports Halftime Report, including the highly anticipated Battle of the Bands.
First up is Southern University, also known as the Human Jukebox. That was the Southern University Human Jukebox Grambling's band, still to come. But when we return, highlights from some of the top 25 teams seeing action this Saturday. And coming up next, more Battle of the Bands featuring Grambling State University's Tiger Marching Band. Back with that after this. Welcome back. The Battle of the Bands continues. Let's take you back down to New Orleans for Grambling State's world-famed Tiger Marching Band. And so the Battle of the Bands is in the books. Coming up, more highlights from the college games and a look ahead to tomorrow's Sunday night football matchup.
Moments away from the start of the third quarter, the State Farm Bayou Classic. Grambling State Tigers on top of the Southern Jaguars 10-6. Now late in the second quarter, Southern starting quarterback J.P. Douglas went out of the game after making a tackle on an interception, did not come back. There you see Dre Joseph, the quarterback who took his place. For an update on the Southern quarterback situation, let's go down to Anthony Heron.
Paul, I spoke to Stump Mitchell as they went into the locker room. He actually told me he anticipated J.P. Douglas returning to the lineup, but the word that Southern has come out of the locker room is that Dre Joseph will be the quarterback for the remainder of this game. J.P. Douglas, they had some concussion symptoms as he went into the locker room. That's why he initially left the lineup there in the second quarter, but the word that Southern has left the locker room here is that J.P. Douglas is out for the remainder of today's ball game.
Anthony, thank you very much. And Dre Joseph taking over. There we see the true freshman quarterback J.P. Douglas, as Anthony described, concussion-like symptoms. And we expect Dre Joseph to lead the way for the Southern offense as we start the third quarter. Paul Burmeister and Sean King in the booth. And on the Grambling sideline is Lewis Johnson. Lewis.
All right, Paul, thanks so much. Talked to Doug Williams as he was leaving after the first half, and he was unhappy with that turnover that gave Southern that touchdown. But he said he was going to hit the chalkboard. Most importantly, he wanted to adjust the blocking scheme for his offensive linemen who need to give their quarterbacks some more protection. And as for his freshman son quarterback, Williams said DJ has played well, but he needs to learn, and I'm sure Sean will agree with this, that there's a clock in that pocket and he needs to get rid of the ball a little bit faster sometimes.
Young quarterback, the thing that jumps off the screen the most, and you're right on target, Lewis, is indecision, not being comfortable, making the throw on time, in rhythm. And when that doesn't happen, especially when you have dynamic defensive linemen trying to get to you, turns into errant throws, turns into sacks, turns into fumbles. Bad plays for your offense.
David Stuckman and Edward Patterson back deep. And this is Patterson. Scooting out to the 35-yard line. Late penalty flag, two penalty flags in. After Patterson went to the 35-yard line.
During the return, illegal block in the back on the return team, number 85, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, first down.
So there's DJ Williams, starting quarterback, freshman quarterback, son of the legend here at Grambling and head coach Doug Williams. 5 for 8, an efficient first half, Sean. And what I like, or if I was in his shoes, I would like the fact that I only had to throw 8 passes as a freshman, and the Tigers ran the ball 27 times.
And were very efficient and effective running the football. You can really dictate what a defense can do from a scheme standpoint if you're having success running the football, but Lewis alluded to it. Doug wants to make some changes on how they're blocking things because Southern linebacker Jamie Payton was a terror for this Grambling offense in the first half.
Dorrance Roberts had 21 carries in the first half alone. Now he has 22 on the first play of the third quarter. That's a gain of 3. And you have been raving about Jamie Payton the entire game, and he is living up to that billing, Sean.
Well, because I like linebackers that make plays. Like, a lot of times we do games and guys have a lot of tackles, but they don't jump off the screen as being disruptive. When you watch Jamie Payton, always in the opposing offense's backfield, loves running through on those running plays, does a good job of reading what's happening. He's a playmaker, and I like that at the linebacker position.
Leading tackler, and that disruptiveness adds teeth to all those numbers that he has. This is second down, 7. DJ Williams firing and almost picked off by Mr. Disruptive himself, Jamie Payton. I bet he'd like another shot at that one.
He would, but if you see the instincts on this play, this is a misdirection for a Mike linebacker. This is going the opposite way. He reads it. I mean, love to see him finish right there, but I'm going to get Jamie Payton drafted before today's broadcast. So. I mean, I am thoroughly impressed with Southern's linebacker. You know, a kid that transferred in from Lambeth University, you know, is now on scholarship here at Southern. They did away with their football program. He's been an integral part of this Southern defense, really making an impact.
Third down and 7, Jaguars bring 4 and firing a strike once again. DJ Williams with time and finds Desmond Spivey. Tigers gain 15.
whatever adjustments Doug Williams made at the half, he mentioned he wanted to adjust how they were pass protecting. It was very effective there. You give DJ a clean pocket. He's a big quarterback, has a strong arm. He'll find the open guy. Look at the anticipation on that throw right inside of that slot defender.
We go. He just waited that extra, just a little bit of hesitation for Spivey to open up over the middle there. Good job of not rushing it by the freshman quarterback.
And for a quarterback, Paul, especially a young quarterback, having a clean pocket is so important. Being able to stand back, be comfortable, have good vision, not have people all at your feet.
And there we see Jamie Payton.
Productivity, a young player.
As Sean has been discussing throughout the afternoon, we've been on his play, and there he is walking off the field, the injured Jaguar. And we'll see if the leading tackler and the leading disruptor on that defense can make his way back to the field. Grambling right now, first and 10 from their own 40-yard line. DJ Williams from the shotgun. Dorrance Roberts scoot his way up the middle. And he continues to find success against that Jaguar rushing defense, especially now without Jamie Payton in there. And that's a gain of 8. And there's Jamie Payton, leading tackler for the Jaguars on the sideline.
And you can see Jamie comes in and tries to break up the pass. I'm not sure what happened, but he ends up on the bottom of that pile.
Second down 2 now for the Grambling Tigers. DJ Williams from the shotgun. Going to keep it himself. Long strides through the middle of that defense. Helmet comes off. And DJ Williams picks up 9.
And Paul, that's a new wrinkle. I mean, you look at DJ Williams and you think athletic running quarterback. He has negative 106 yards rushing this season, so he's not really been a component of the Grambling running game, but looks like they added a new wrinkle for today's Bayou class.
The helmet came off of Jared Dietrich there, and it's such a difference, a study in contrast, when you see him kind of just go through there with the long strides after watching Dorrance Roberts so quickly cut through the hole like that.
Paul, I was joking with him this week leading up to this game, and I say, DJ, how do you rush for negative 106 yards? Just don't see how that's possible. And he was like, the sacks, man, the sacks.
It's Dorrance Roberts finding holes and that quickness bursting right up the middle. And the Southern defense came into this game last in the Southwest Athletic Conference in rushing D. And the Grambling State Tigers well aware, giving Dorrance Roberts 21 carries in the first half, 3 already in the second half. And the Tigers are well into Jaguar territory. We'll see if they have another first down.
And I know I've been ranting, raving about Southern linebacker Jamie Payton. He exits 2 plays ago with an injury, and all of a sudden, Dorrance Roberts gains 9 yards and then 6 yards back-to-back on 2 carries.
But as you mentioned, he's the kind of linebacker who not only has the numbers coming into this one as the leading tackler, but you see him all over the field. Pass defense, rush defense. His absence certainly felt by the Jaguars. Now with second down, a little bit less than 1.
And this is that point in the field where you really got to be careful. You see Mario Lewis right there, the outstanding Grambling back. This is when you take a shot. Second and short, probably going to get those safeties a little close to the line of scrimmage, get some man-on-man coverage.
Mario Lewis is down here, one against one, man coverage. He is open. Ball to him. Touchdown, Mario Lewis. One hand for number 1. Yards, DJ Williams to Mario Lewis. Second time that connection is hooked up for a touchdown today.
And this is just man-to-man coverage. Virgil Williams has a size disadvantage versus Mario Lewis, about 4 inches shorter. And you see Super Mario with the showboat, the one-handed catch. He's having fun today in the Bayou Classic.
2 catches, 61 yards. Productive 2 catches for Mario Lewis, both going for touchdowns.
16 touchdown catches on the season. He's been very productive, you know, and that's even more impressive to me when you look at the fact that he's played with inexperience at the quarterback position. I mean, what he's been able to do this season has just been unbelievable.
Game-winning touchdown in the fourth quarter, last game out, 34-yard reception against Texas Southern. stays hot here in the Bayou Classic with two touchdown receptions.
Offense. 5 yard penalty remained the point after touchdown attempt.
That's Corey Robinson.
And sometimes you overlook the throw in that kind of play. Great job by DJ of really dropping that football right into the bucket.
Yeah, put that one up high. Just brought it down to the perfect spot. Zoltan Riazzo up and in. Mario Lewis came into this game with 14 touchdown receptions. He has two touchdown catches today, the most recent with just one hand. The Tigers extend that lead early in the third quarter. The State Farm Bayou Classic is brought to you by McDonald's. I'm loving it. And by State Farm, proud title sponsor of the Bayou Classic. John King spent 4 years here in New Orleans. You know all about the flavor down here.
That looks awesome.
It did look good.
I actually had duck for the first time last night.
And?
Yeah, very good. With the Tommy's restaurant, I was very pleased.
A little gamey?
No, I actually liked it. It was really good.
Darrell Alex and Virgil Williams deep. This is Virgil Williams bringing it back. Nice return out to the 34-yard line. Mario Lewis now with two touchdown receptions. We have a flag down on the play. Our referee this afternoon is Roderick Holloway.
After the play, personal foul, late hit out of bounds on the kicking team, number 57, 15 yards added to the end of the run, first down.
Mario Lewis with two touchdown receptions today. For more on his story, we go down to Lewis Johnson.
And Paul, you guys have accurately referred to him as Super Mario. We ask him where that name came from. He said it's his father who gave him that name when he was about 10 years old. His dad, Craig Lewis, is in the stands. There he is holding up the gray sweatshirt on the left. Mom Myra's there, five brothers and sisters. And Mr. Lewis said that he remembers watching Mario play basketball at a recreation park just outside of New Orleans many years ago, and said his kid was just a star. He was making unreal shots, covered the entire gym, but his dad encouraged him to try football, and that's what led him to become a wide receiver from Grambling. And if I ask his dad, you know, one word for Mario other than super, and he says spectacular. And I guess that probably describes that last touchdown catch we saw, too.
Yeah, only one hand, Lewis. And I think his numbers have been spectacular recently. In the five-game winning streak that Grambling came into this game with, eight touchdown receptions. Go ahead and make it 10 in the last five-plus games. Firing the football for the Southern offense now is Dre Joseph. And fighting for extra yardage and doing a nice job of it. Lee Doss, gain of 14.
And, Paul, when I first entered the National Football League, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers were still in the NFC Central at the time. Randy Moss used to catch every pat and go throw with that one hand. That's what that reminded me of on Mario Lewis's touchdown.
Yeah, only two catches here today, but both going for touchdowns. Dre Joseph, 5'11", sophomore, true sophomore from Edgard, Louisiana, and he is laying on the turf. Cliff Exama is in there. So too is Stuart Hine. Grambling now with four sacks this afternoon.
You know, and Dre's played a lot this year. Came into the game 12 touchdowns to eight interceptions, but that clock has to go off. You see that pressure coming. No one's available. Throw that football away. Don't take the sack if you can get rid of the football.
And Stone Mitchell has to like what he has here in a backup quarterback. You don't want to go to the backup, but with J.P. Douglas on the sideline after playing most of the first half, Dre Joseph comes in having started the first six games this season and actually started their last game before he gave way to J.P. Douglas. Nine touchdowns and five interceptions so far this season. A little bit off there looking at Charles Hawkins.
And Charles Hawkins is looking back at Dre Joseph and saying, Please don't do that to me. You throw that skinny post, young quarterbacks, you have to put that football right inside the body frame of that wide receiver so he can catch it. You don't want to have him extended and stretching out. It's a little inaccurate on this throw by Dre Joseph.
Accuracy normally on the side of Dre Joseph coming into this one, 54%, just a little bit better than J.P. Douglas, who started the game. He came in at 51%. Third down and 20. Now from the 44-yard line. Makes the draw and goes right down again. Stuart Hine in on the sack for the second time in this series. That's a loss of five.
Stump Mitchell told me this week, guys, that recognition and composure are two reasons that J.P. Douglas was able to bypass and become the starter in this offense. And that's an excellent example of it right there.
Doug Williams' defense producing five sacks already this afternoon. Still over 9 minutes to go in the third quarter. Manuel Canto, busy man this afternoon, back to punt once again. That's his sixth punt. And that one just lands out of bounds. Jamie Payton will be back on the field for the Southern defense with his team trailing 17-6.
Yeah, I'm married. Doesn't matter. You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's...
State Farm Bayou Classic continues with Grambling leading 17-6. Check out the sea of State Farm red in the end zone. Thanks to our sponsor, State Farm, always working to get you a better state. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. I'll tell you who's been there for the Grambling offense so far is the tailback, Dorrance Roberts. 24 carries already for 95 yards. Play action. DJ Williams under pressure and going down. Jalen Jordan with a sack. Third sack of the afternoon for the Southern defense.
It's going to be big for that Southern defensive front to continue to find a way to pressure DJ Williams in the pocket without bringing the additional blitzers from the edge. You have to be able to let a young quarterback feel you, not let him be so comfortable in the pocket.
DJ Williams right now 7 out of 11 for 131 yards and a couple of touchdowns. Dorrance Roberts back with the football. Up, and the ball is out. Recovered by Southern. The Southern offense will be in business. That is the fourth turnover of the afternoon committed by Grambling.
Paul, very difficult for me not to think that the ground didn't cause that fumble. We'll get a better look at it here.
But Doug Williams not happy about that call. No reviews here. Plays not reviewable, so call on the field will stand. Dre Joseph, first and 10 from the 19. Sylvester and Zeke to the 17-yard line, gain of 2. Doug Williams thought that was not a fumble. It was called a fumble on the field. Dorrance Roberts. And the ground is not supposed to cause the fumble.
Once that elbow hits, he's down. But
tackled by Virgil Williams. Dorrance Roberts. Ball comes out. Once again, plays not reviewable. Southwestern Athletic Conference. Second down, 8. Dre Joseph. Lee Doss inside the 5-yard line. Lee Doss already with a touchdown this afternoon. That one from J.P. Douglas. Now a gain of 12 from Dre Joseph.
They've had a lot of success with Lee Doss on crossing routes. He scored earlier from the slot on a slant route. And he's someone that I would look for to get down in this area on the five-yard line. They have not had a lot of success running the football. It gets very difficult to throw the football in the interior of that defense because of the amount of people in a small, confined space.
First down and goal from the five-yard line. Dre Joseph filling in for the injured J.P. Douglas. Knocking on that scoring door. Back to the air. Back across the middle. Touchdown, Southern. Yards out.
Michael Berry came into the game with 6 touchdowns, tied for the lead with Smoke Evans. He's a guy they look for when they get in that red zone, that scoring area. Good throw by the quarterback, Dre Joseph. Very accurate, on time, in rhythm.
We mentioned what an advantage it must be for Stump Mitchell to go with the backup quarterback who's already started 7 games this season, and the Jaguars now going for 2. Trailing 17-12, trying to get that deficit to 3.
They have their best receiver, Smoke Evans, up here on a one-on-one situation.
Out of the backfield to him, Zeke Wade trying to leap his way into the end zone. Didn't quite get there. Heck of an effort by Sylvester and Zeke, catching the ball out of the backfield, but just inside the 1, does not pick up the 2.
Sylvester and Zeke, the leading ball carrier here for Southern with 526 yards, a walk-on trying to earn that scholarship. Outstanding individual athletic play. Southern capitalizes on the turnover. New ball game, 17-12 here in New Orleans.
You see. Doug Williams, Grambling Tigers, just giving up the touchdown. 17-12, 6:47 left. And 4 Tiger turnovers led to 12 points for the Southern Jaguars.
And if you're Doug Williams, this has to be frustrating for you. You almost have to start sort of be getting nervous. A lot on the line for Grambling today. With a victory, they win the Western Division of the Southwestern Athletic Conference and will play in that conference's championship game. So it's a lot at stake. No, Doug is very frustrated with the turnovers. They actually probably frustrated at the official for what I think was a missed call on that fumble.
Edward Patterson is deep for Grambling, takes it on the 12-yard line. And he's got some room. Out across the 40-yard line, we do have a penalty marker on the field. And we'll check in with Roderick Holloway.
End of the run. Grambling will remain possession of the ball. First down.
And Sean, you mentioned that Grambling now 1 win away from playing in the Southwestern Athletic Conference title game December 10th in Alabama in Birmingham. And that seemed like a long way away for Doug Williams about a month and a half ago. But the team has not lost since October 1st, 5 consecutive wins. And a retooled offense as he's in his first year here. Freshman quarterback. 5 wins in a row to end the regular season. Not so bad. Going for a number 6 in a row today. That's Dorrance Roberts. His last carry ended in a fumble. That's a gain of 3.
And Dorrance only gained about a yard and a half right there. And that's obviously because Jamie Payton is back into the game at linebacker for Southern. Another stop. Terrific ball game. I think he's an outstanding player. Some NFL team is going to be better next year because he's on it.
Second down, 8. Jamie Payton making a living so far this afternoon in that Grambling backfield. Dorrance Roberts right up the middle, running right at Payton. Gain of 2. Dorrance Roberts now with 27 carries this afternoon, just inside of 6 minutes left in the third quarter.
Paul Roberts had to work his way into the role of being the workhorse running back in this offense. He was not the starter earlier in the season because he had some ball security issues. And so that fumble that appeared to be a missed call by the officials, it's doubly disappointing for a guy like Roberts who had really shored it up. And he talked to us about the practice drills that he's worked throughout the remainder of the season to try and be more secure with the football.
Third down and five to the air. It's going to be awfully close to a first down. DJ Williams to Jeremiah Hernandez, gain of four, just short of a Tiger first.
And I think if you're Doug Williams and this is short, you almost have to go for this on fourth down. Now that Dre Joseph has been in the game, I know JP got injured and is replacing him because of that. That Southern offense seems to be finding their rhythm a little bit. You don't want to turn around and give them the football right back.
Doug Williams not happy on the sideline. Fourth down, less than a yard.
Now, last time they had fourth down, Paul, they ran a counter play, which I don't like because that lineman has to pull and can get knocked back into the back. Let's see if they do something a little more downhill on this fourth and short.
The tailback is Kenneth Batiste. He gets it, puts that head down, and he is met right at the first down marker. Going to be all up to the spot. Looked like he had a little gap there, Sean, for half a second. Did get just enough for that first down.
And he got it, but again, I'm surprised by the play caller. You know what I mean? This lineman that pulls right there and comes down the screen, that can create disruption in the backfield, but it does look as if Darius Roberts got just enough to pick up the first down.
Marlon Smith, nice job of filling from the safety position. And it's now first down and 10 from the 40. And if Batiste stays in the game, trying to scoot through the middle of that Jaguar defense, doesn't quite make it out of that interior. Gain of three. And a tackle made by Dexter James.
And you may ask yourself, why is Grambling still attempting to run the football? Have not had a lot of success in the second half. But this does two things, Paul. It shortens the game. It keeps your defense on the sideline. Doug Williams is trying to find a way to get out of the Mercedes-Benz Superdome with the victory today.
And look at that total yardage. Dominated by Torrance Roberts and the Grambling State Tigers. But keep in mind, four turnovers committed by the offense. Well, three by the offense, one by the special teams. Really keeping Southern in this one. That's a gain of one. Third down and six. And you mentioned it's a goal of shortening the game. I think it's also a goal not to put DJ Williams in too many positions where he's forced to throw. Might be in one of those right now on third down and six. Converted on third down and five moments ago. Now inside 3 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Jaguars bring four. Excellent catch by Hernandez. DJ Williams gave him a chance, and Hernandez took advantage.
The skills are there, Paul. I mean, the size is there, the arm strength. You see the moxie. This is a throw against zone. It's over the underneath coverage. It's under the deep coverage. Great catch by Jeremiah Hernandez, but the confidence of the young quarterback to try and fit that football into a very tight window.
The ball was tipped. That's an even better catch by Jeremiah Hernandez than we thought. Nice job of stepping up and firing a strike by DJ Williams. As you mentioned, that takes confidence to push that ball in there over those linebackers. Doug Williams going to talk it over with his son. We'll take a break with the Tigers leading 17-12.
The anticipation builds. An entire season leads to this. We will see who rises, who stands up to be the next legend. On December 10th, a new champion will prevail. 2011 Farmers Insurance SWAC Football Championship, presented by Toyota.
Grambling State Tigers on the move, already with a 5-point lead, 2:22 left in the third quarter, and freshman quarterback DJ Williams right now first and 10 on the 12-yard line. Couple of touchdown passes already. Dorrance Roberts, tailback behind him. Taking another shot. Mario Lewis has three catches and three touchdowns.
And Paul, this is a big time throw. from the far hash, been able to throw that slant route to the wide side of the field with velocity and great location. I mean, you have to be impressed by the freshman quarterback, DJ Williams from Grambling. He came into the game. He talked to me this week. He said, listen, Sean, I want to create my own legacy here at Grambling. He's starting to do that today.
Extra point up and in by Zoltan Briazzo. And the Tigers now doubling up on the Jaguars, 24-12. Three catches and three touchdowns. Mario Lewis, awfully productive with those three catches. Well, his daddy has four wins against Southern. DJ Williams in his first game now has three touchdown passes. And the Tigers lead 24-12. State Farm is proud to sponsor the 2011 Bayou Classic. For the past 16 years, State Farm has enjoyed sponsoring this great rivalry game. State Farm is proud to present Grambling State and Southern University grants, which are worth $155,000 and will benefit their scholarship programs. Over the last 16 years, State Farm has donated more than $3 million to Southern and Grambling. Southern head coach Stump Mitchell, former NFL running back, now finds his Jaguars trailing 24-12, 2 minutes 16 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Mario Lewis moments ago hauling in his third touchdown catch this afternoon. Football on the ground. Southern attempting to go with the reverse on the return. Put the ball on the turf and the Jaguars bounce back on it. Stump Mitchell operating with his backup quarterback now. As we take a look at the attempted botched reverse, that was Terrell Alex initially with the football, trying to give it to LaMarcus Petaway, and Southern eventually recovers that fumble.
You know, Paul, I'm not sure I'm comfortable with that little underhanded flip. They tried to pass the football off, but I'd much rather, you know, use a more secure handoff, but luckily for Southern, they were able to recover that fumble.
Javondon Valare recovering the fumble, and it's now first down and 10 from the 12-yard line. Dre Joseph has been hot in the second half and leaves that one a little bit too far behind Jordan Bilbo, and it'll be second down 10.
As Dre Joseph re-enters the lineup here, important for us to remember, he's only a sophomore at this point also. Played last season as a freshman quarterback and was being groomed a bit to become the starting quarterback this season. He was just bypassed at some point by J.P. Douglas because he became the front runner at the quarterback position more recently. But Dre Joseph, they've got a lot of confidence in the natural tools that he has to play the quarterback position. So this drive here, if he can continue to keep them in this ball game, it could keep him in position to be the starter going into next season.
Dre Joseph, the true sophomore, stepping up out of the shotgun position, left it behind Bilbo that time. He put it right on him there for a gain of 16.
And Jordan Bilbo's an interesting player for Southern. Actually gave their freshman quarterback, J.P. Douglas, a hard time. Would you believe, Paul, in the game, the first game of the season against Tennessee State, J.P.'s first pass was a 65-yard touchdown to Jordan Bilbo, yet he came in the game with only five catches. He's trying to figure out why J.P. has gotten away from throwing to him. Looks like Dre has figured out that Jordan Bilbo is a pretty good wide receiver.
He's been the target two times in a row. That time for a first down, and back to the air is Joseph, and intercepted by Cliff Exama. The leading tackler for the Tigers comes up with a pick.
And Anthony alluded to Dre Joseph and him trying to reassert himself as a starter. This is the reason that Dre was replaced for JP early in the season. He really struggled with throwing interceptions in Southern's first couple of games. So has to be disappointed for Stump Mitchell. Just a bad read by the young quarterback.
Stump Mitchell so upset he can't even stand next to Dre Joseph.
It's about the eyes here for the quarterback. As a linebacker, you know you can stand position to try and undercut some of these out passes that Dre Joseph is throwing. And Cliff Exama has been as productive as any linebacker in the recent history of SWAC football.
After his last game, earned Southwestern Athletic Conference Player of the Week, had the off week, and now already with a sack and an interception. Dorrance Roberts trying to turn the corner, nowhere to cut back. That Jaguar defense there in a big way. Trey Tiller from his defensive line position throws it for a loss of four.
the numbers really do a disservice to this Southern defense because they've kept this football team in games throughout the season where the offense has turned the football over, as we repeatedly see them doing today. But the defense has continued to bow up at different points and continue to keep them in these games. So the coaching staff feels confident that their defense can step up and make plays.
Now inside a minute in the third quarter, second down 14. Penalty marker on the play.
Prior to the snap, the play. Second down, with the Southern band refrain from playing while the snap is imminent. First warning.
The human jukebox just got warned, Sean.
I wasn't sure where he was going right there. Man, he's trying to get it together.
Dorrance Roberts to the bench to take a break, and Kenneth Batiste now the tailback to the right of DJ Williams to the air. Intercepted. That one looked high coming off of his hand, and Michael Bell with the interception.
Southern went to their three-man front. That's the defensive front they like to pressure the quarterback after, because in that three you have no idea where the additional rushes may come from. And so when you're facing a young quarterback, can you get a guy like DJ Williams to see some ghosts? There was a seam there. I know you saw it, Sean, but it was just a hair late. And that set up Michael Bell for the pick.
And that's a difficult throw. Anytime that wide receiver in that slot position goes inside of that defender, it makes it a very difficult throw. And the compound that he threw it high, it's a bad turnover for Grambling because they had a chance to really take control of this game if they could have scored and finished off that drive.
That turnover has been a theme here as Dre Joseph. Well, he's not afraid to fire that ball over the middle, is he? That's a strike to Charles Hawkins for a gain of 17. Do have a penalty marker on the play.
Chop block, number 74 offense. Half the distance to the goal. Replay, first down.
Zach Brown, offensive lineman, the freshman out of Missouri City, Texas.
One of three freshmen that play on that offensive line for Southern. They also have three freshmen that they're rotating as a part of their defensive front. Very young team for Stump Mitchell. They will get better as they gain experience, but there's going to be some of that inconsistency, especially from a penalty standpoint when you have that many young guys playing.
You're looking at a young quarterback there as well. Dre Joseph is a true sophomore, standing in his own end zone and down in his own end zone.
The play is ruled, the quarterback being tackled in the end zone. Safety by rule.
Antonio
Leonard is mistake from the 20-yard line.
Antonio Leonard in from his defensive end position. Stump Mitchell says step up, throw it away, don't take the safety.
You've got to have a clock, especially when you get backed up, bad field position because of the penalty. You know you're standing in your own end zone. You've got to go bang, bang, and either run it or throw it away.
You two old quarterbacks, you know it. There has to be that clock in your head when your heels are in the end zone. And as a defensive lineman, as Antonio Leonard comes off the corner right there, he is just licking his chops, hoping that the football is still in the QB's hands.
And Anthony, you played defensive end of the Big Ten, also the National Football League. Can you tell, can you sense that when a quarterback is just has a knack for hanging on a little bit too long?
When you see the offensive tackle's cut block, that is the key sign that the ball is supposed to be gone quick. But excellent job by Leonard there, using his hands, playing off the cut block. And as soon as you don't end up on the ground, you have got to be able to burst towards the passer. That is precisely what Leonard did.
And Dre Joseph will be disappointed. As a quarterback, you hate to look at the film when you're evaluating your performance and have unforced errors. You know, errors that occurred, you know, they're preventable. And that was one there for the very easily throwing the football away.
Back-to-back drives ending with errors from Dre Joseph. Cliff Exambo picked him off, and then he comes right back, hangs on to it, and gets sacked. Six sacks now on the afternoon for the Grambling defense. David Stuckman with the return, trying to hang on to that ball. Penalty marker down on the 38-yard line as Stuckman got out to the 47. The human jukebox got challenged there, Sean.
Yeah, and they haven't stopped playing since the official challenged them. Sounds pretty melodic to me. Keep playing, jukebox.
During the return, illegal block below the waist, number 33 on the return team, 15 yards from the spot of the foul, grabbing the return, possession of the ball, first down.
I think we have both bands going at it now. The human jukebox for Southern, the Marching Tigers for Grambling State. And a scowl from Southern head coach Stump Mitchell. Go ahead, Lewis.
Without question, Battle of the Bands part two is, well, it just ended. How do you figure that, huh? Just when they begin to play so loud. But these two bands are in the opposite corners of the stadium, and it's just a competition that doesn't stop, just like on the field.
Dennis would know better than any of us. This is, what, his 50th Bayou Classic he's been at. He's the mayor of New Orleans, essentially, at this point.
Associate mayor.
I think Sean considers himself the deputy associate mayor.
Yeah, but I would like to have Lewis, you know, as a part of my...
He's on your committee?
Yeah, part of my team.
Dorrance Roberts sidestepping Jaguars in the backfield and still going. Dorrance Roberts is running free. Virgil Williams, the final Jaguar with a shot, dragging him out of bounds. What a piece of running by Dorrance Roberts. ...68-yard run by Dorrance Roberts. Mario Lewis, three touchdown catches on the afternoon, and the Tigers with a lead heading into the fourth quarter. Grambling with a big third quarter, couple of touchdowns, and also a safety, and now a 14-point lead at 26-12 as we are set to begin the fourth quarter here in the 38th annual State Farm Bayou Classic. Dorrance Roberts now with his 31st carry of the afternoon. That's a gain of one. Give him 31 carries for 161 yards. Let's go down to Lewis Johnson.
We were talking to Doug Williams this week, and we said when he sees Dorrance Roberts in practice, what does he see? And he was reminded of what Coach Eddie Robinson would say about a player who looks one way in practice and another way on the game. He said Coach Rob would say he looks like a pork chop, but he plays like a steak. And I tell you, Dorrance Roberts has played like a beautifully marbleized cut of meat today, without question.
Oh, he's met there at the 10-yard line on his 32nd carry. And it's ironic, guys. He only had two carries in the first three games. Only two.
And it looked like they found a running back, Frank Warren, who graduated last year. I mean, was so accomplished of a runner for this Grambling football team. That was a position where they had to find a fill-in. And you look at Dorrance, not really a powerful, low-to-the-ground type of runner, not a scat-back Reggie Bushish, but he's slippery. He's one of those guys that's very difficult to bring down, always finds a way to get out of that initial contact.
Third down and eight now. DJ Williams looking to Mario Lewis once again. Does he have his fourth touchdown? No. He thought he had it in bounds, but he's the only one who feels that way. And it'll be fourth down.
And in or out, this is just a tremendous throw by the freshman quarterback, DJ, and also a great catch by Mario Williams. You see so many wide receivers that don't have the coordination, the athleticism to high point the football. He goes up off the wrong leg, high points the football, and that's as close as you can get to being in and we can call out. I mean, tremendous individual effort by Super Mario as he goes by. I mean, there are some impressive players on the football field today.
Once again, plays not reviewable in the Southwest Athletic Conference. Zoltan Riazzo makes his second field goal of the afternoon. Doug Williams Tigers increase the lead to 17.
Aaron, you're all set.
Great, thanks.
Mike, thanks for doing that discount double check. You saved us hundreds.
What was that?
The discount double check?
The State Farm Bayou Classic is brought to you by State Farm. Get to a better state. Doug Williams, Grambling, Tigers getting to a better state here inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome, leading now 29-12.
Is that real?
I think that actually happened.
Wow.
LaQuinton Evans, top wide receiver for the Southern Jaguars, bringing that one back. Tackle for the Tigers, special teams made by David Smith, sophomore defensive back out of Birmingham, Alabama. Dre Joseph looking to get this thing going back in the right direction. Third quarter had the interception, followed up by the safety, held on to it a little long and was sacked in the end zone by Antonio Leonard. Stump Mitchell needing better play from his offense, trailing by 17, 13:31 left in the fourth quarter. Joseph back to the air, one step and fire. Complete to Lee Doss. Already with a touchdown today, that's a gain of 9.
There's a noticeable absence of LaQuinton Evans from the Southern offense. He's been in the lineup, but they haven't gotten him the football consistently. Stump Mitchell talked to us about the frustration that comes up at times where Evans just seems to disappear from the passing attack.
Dre Joseph. Pass incomplete, and on that one, Anthony, right to LaQuinton Evans.
You know the one thing that they don't do with LaQuinton that Doug does a good job of doing with Mario Lewis, they don't give him opportunities to make plays in one-on-one situations down the field. Everything that I've seen with LaQuinton today has been the hitch routes, you know, the drive routes running across the field. I think they need to give him some opportunities to make some plays in one-on-one situations.
He had a season-low one catch against Florida A&M, and ever since then, he's been hot. 28 catches in the last five games. Four of those going for touchdowns, right at 400 total receiving yards. Dre Joseph stepping up, maybe with a little bit too much on that one to lead off as it falls incomplete.
One thing that I should certainly point out here, guys, is that as LaQuinton Evans has left the field a couple of different times, they've worked on his lower body. He's had some leg issues going at different points in the game. Spoke to the training staff here on the Southern sideline. They say he's good to go, haven't had any issues, but they have worked on the left leg several times, so that could be. No speculation on what a potential injury would be, but that could be, if it factors in, why they're not running him downfield more as a 4-3-40 player.
A lead off there on the sideline. This is fourth down and one for the Southern offense this season. 7 out of 19 converting fourth down situations. Dre Joseph to the air on fourth and one. And you can't throw it any better than that. Justin Williams could not come down with it. Grambling State offense will be back on the field leading 29-12. The State Farm Bayou Classic. Get to a better state. State Farm. 12:54 left in the fourth quarter. Southern offense fails to convert on fourth down, turning it right over to DJ Williams and the Tiger offense on the 34-yard line. That's a gain of 2. And the clock will continue to move. And I would imagine here, Sean King, that the Grambling offense going to lean heavily on the run game here with a 17-point lead.
I wouldn't put it past Doug Williams, though, to try and get his son, their starting quarterback, DJ Williams, another touchdown. I wouldn't be surprised to see some kind of play-action pass trying to get Mario Lewis another touchdown at some point.
He already has three catches, three touchdowns. Back to the run game. Dorrance Roberts trying to turn that corner. Burst, and he does. Turns it into a touchdown. I see it. Dorrance Roberts from 32 yards out.
I called him slippery, Paul. Just one of those backs. Just keeps extending the run, keeps extending the run. And before you know it, he's up the sideline. Touchdown, Grambling.
Making Doug Williams smile on the sideline. And there was a little moment there, Sean, where it looked like he was just going to run out of bounds. And he turned that hesitation into a big burst at 6 points. Doug Williams' son has three touchdown tosses tonight. Dorrance Roberts has a 32-yard score. And the Grambling Tigers in the Bayou Classic all over Stump Mitchell's Jaguars right now, 36-12. Dorrance Roberts' 33rd carry of the afternoon. Good for a Tiger touchdown.
And give a big fella some credit, too. Their right guard, sophomore Clint Marsh, out there leading that power sweep. Took care of his responsibility. Linebacker got to that second level, picked up a defensive back. I mean, you can see guys have really bought into Doug Williams and what he's preaching. They play with energy. They play with effort. You know, they have some young guys that the future looks really bright. They're going to get an opportunity to play in the SWAC championship game next weekend. I mean, you look at his offense. Dorrance Roberts comes back. DJ Williams will be back. They'll lose Mario Lewis probably to the National Football League, but one of those other guys to step up. We saw Jeremiah Hernandez earlier in the game.
The Southwestern Athletic Conference championship game is December 10th, and right now the Grambling State Tigers in good position. A little over 12 minutes left and leading 36-12. Back deep, Terrell Alex and LaQuinton Evans. This is Evans. Run out of bounds near the 28-yard line. You saw Doug Williams, a lot of hugs and smiles on the sidelines. And yes, he was 4-0 against Southern in the Bayou Classic as a quarterback from 74 to 77. But as a coach, keep in mind, he was the head coach that replaced Eddie Robinson in 1998. He went 1-5 in this game. This is his first stint back, so he's looking for just his second victory in seven tries against the arch rival.
And Paul, Doug Williams was really, really good. Like, if Doug Williams came along now, I mean, you think Cam Newton is big? I mean, his skill set was unbelievable. His ability to throw the football, I mean, he was amazing. I've gotten an opportunity to watch, you know, some of those games from back in the day. I mean, the things that he was able to do at the quarterback position, I mean, it's unbelievable. Finished fourth in the Heisman, you know, as a quarterback at Grambling back in the 70s. You know, that's how good of a player, you know, Doug Williams was.
He was the first team All-American quarterback his senior year in 1977, and finishing fourth, as you mentioned, Sean, the year Earl Campbell won it out of Grambling. I mean, he had an unbelievable run, over 8,000 career passing yards.
Like, it's fascinating to me what he could have been if he came along now. You know, he went to Tampa, you know, couldn't get his contract situation figured out. You know, was forced to go to the USFL for 4 years. You know, everyone knows that he came back and, you know, played for the Redskins and won Super Bowl 22 and was the MVP. But just think about if he was here now and went straight into the National Football League, the statistics that he could have accumulated.
So Cliff Exama, the star linebacker for Grambling State, down for a moment. Let's go down to the Grambling sideline and check in with Lewis Johnson.
And as you guys continue to wax poetic about Doug Williams and what he did, remember it was little DJ who first saw his dad on videotape about 5 or 6 years old, said he couldn't believe that was his father. He was so proud. Said he remembers, you know, watching it, but doesn't know exactly when he was inspired, but shortly after popping that tape, that's when he decided ultimately he wanted to be like his father and be a quarterback. And look at him, here he is as a freshman.
Third down and 15, ball on the ground, and Dre Joseph just falls on it to bring up fourth down and forever for the Southern offense.
And Paul, Doug was an inspiration for me. You know, I'm from St. Petersburg, Florida, so I grew up a Buck fan, you know, back with the Bucko Bruce orange and white days. And I mean, he was just a standout player throughout his career. It's got to be an awesome experience to not only be able to coach your son, but to have a son as talented and with the skill set that DJ has. That's got to just be great.
And just think back 1 year ago today, how far away this opportunity seemed. Doug Williams was in Virginia. He was the general manager of the UFL team Virginia Destroyers. And his son DJ, well, he wasn't here either. He was at Hargrave Military Academy in Virginia. And now here they are, quarterback and father, starting quarterback and head coach. Ball takes a Southern bounce. Down to the 42-yard line, punts of 47 yards. There's Doug Williams talking to his son, DJ Williams, providing encouragement there on the sideline. David, like that moment, David Stuckman, after he just fumbled the punt. Looks like right there, that's a look of, why did you do that?
And you know, what's more impressive is you get a sense for how big DJ is. Everyone knows that Doug's a big guy, you know, 6'4", solid. DJ, you know, has that frame. You know, once he develops, puts on a little weight, I mean, he's going to have the size necessary, you know, to play that position.
Doug Williams with perhaps the greatest quarter in Super Bowl history against the Denver Broncos, throwing four touchdown passes in a 42-10 rout. A lot of people don't remember that in the NFC title game the week before, he was only 9 for 26,
yeah,
against the Minnesota Vikings. So quite a turnaround in that week.
I've had a couple 9 for 26 type days.
It gets forgotten about in a hurry when you have the best quarter in Super Bowl history. And Mario Lewis with three touchdown receptions now with the end around, waiting for the block. And then turns it up. You see him patting big Clint Marshall on the backside, saying, hurry up and throw that block, big fella.
Clint Marshall has proved that he can pull around from right guard and make plays on the edge. But if you see that mouth is open, he's trying to catch his breath. He's probably looking to the sideline. Okay, coach, that's enough.
First down and 10, clock ticking now inside of 9 minutes and 30 seconds.
Oh, wing T formation by Grambling.
DJ Williams to the air. Bit of a surprise, and now Mario Lewis has a catch that's not a touchdown reception. Gain of 3. In attendance here today, a quarterback who came before Doug Williams, James Harris, played 65 to 68 here at Grambling, then 12 years in the National Football League. I talked to him last night. He said that unbelievable quarter that Doug Williams had in the Super Bowl, routine day at Grambling.
Yeah.
We've seen that hundreds of times before.
Shaq Harris, longtime executive in the Jacksonville Jaguars organization.
Now a senior executive in personnel with the Lions. Clock is stopped on the field. Roderick Holloway says go ahead and start it again as we approach the 9-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Grambling on top 36-12.
And Paul, I can envision when you were a young quarterback, this is the offense that you ran. Now it's called the wing tee. Couple tight ends in the game, three running backs. All the quarterback does, turn around and hand off.
You think that's all we could do in the state of Iowa?
Run the wing tee. I'm expecting that. That's what your high school tape looks like.
We might have had a little bit of that in there. I don't think we leaned too heavily upon it, though.
And Paul, I've been doing my research. I pulled some Iowa tape, and you're a pretty good player.
I don't know what tape you saw. It wasn't with the wing tee, though, I can tell you that. Doug Williams, 17th overall selection. Back in the 1978 draft to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Freshman quarterback and son now handing off to Dorrance Roberts. Wisely trying to stay in bounds out as he approaches the 40-yard line.
And I know we've talked a lot about Grambling, you know, right here lately, but if you're Stump Mitchell, you know, you're still evaluating, you're still analyzing. You want to see which one of your guys are going to continue to play hard, who's going to finish. You know, when the game gets out of hand like it is now, who still is assignment perfect, who makes plays. Like, there are guys right now, and young players a lot of times don't think they realize that these situations can really be springboards for you to become a starter, for you to create a presence for yourself among your ball club.
And keep in mind, Stump Mitchell really changed the offensive culture here when he arrived for the 2010 season. It was kind of a Texas Tech-like attack that they had, and he's more under the center, West Coast offense. Spent 8 seasons coaching in Seattle, learned the Mike Holmgren way. Of course, Mike Holmgren, a disciple of the Bill Walsh West Coast system. And he's installing a version of that here at Southern.
And you can hear the excitement in his voice because he sees it evolving. You know, when you look at the talent that's on the field, there's not a large separation between Grambling and Southern. Southern's just a little more inexperienced. Those young guys are getting older. They've played in this game a couple times. Going to finish the year, looks like 4-7. But he looks like, he thinks they're close. He thinks that they're starting to get the system. They're starting to buy in. They're starting to realize the expectation and standard that he has for this Southern program. And he thinks the sky's the limit next year.
So J.P. Douglas, the quarterback who started for the Jaguars, on the sideline giving way to Dre Joseph. Virgil Williams calling for the fair catch and going down, making it a difficult fair catch after a punt of 34 yards. Here is the teamwork moment play of the game brought to you by the United States Marine Corps.
And you just look at the way Mario Lewis catches the football with his hands out in front of his body. He showed so many characteristics and attributes of being an elite top end type of wide receiver, and the young quarterback had disappointed us today. A lot of pressure on DJ Williams coming into this ball game. He's lived up to the expectations. I even think he's exceeded what some people thought he was capable of doing on this type of stage.
That was the teamwork moment play of the game brought to you by the United States Marine Corps. Dre Joseph standing in his own end zone. Last time we saw that, he took a safety. And that's a big hit. Cedric Goins after a gain of 9. Stump Mitchell will continue to evaluate this pass offense led now by Dre Joseph. And that's a big hit.
And you said it right.
Sylvester and Zeke, that's Cedric Goins. Dre Joseph with an excellent touch pass to Michael Berry. Berry has a 5-yard touchdown reception today. Joseph to Berry for 28 yards.
And that's an impressive throw. It was in rhythm. It was on time. You know, and if I'm Stump Mitchell, you know, right before this drive, I pulled Dre Joseph to the side and said, listen, go run our offense, get completions, move the football. You know, this is a football game. We play the full 4 quarters. I want to see you execute this offense.
Dre Joseph now right at 50%, now a little bit better. Coming underneath, the completion to Charles Hawkins. Picks up another Southern first down after a gain of 16.
We know the NFL history of Doug Williams, and Stump Mitchell really wants to be able to groom this Southern program in a very similar way, where he puts players in positions to have an opportunity to go and to play well at the next level. You look at the wide receiver position between LaQuinton Evans, Charles Hawkins. They want to be able to showcase the skill set of different guys playing multiple positions as they would have to in the NFL.
Dre Joseph firing incomplete that time, looking for Berry.
He's described it as building an all-around versatile type of football player, and that's what you need to be able to be if you're really going to get showcased for NFL scouts. You want to be a scheme-diverse type of guy, and that's why I know he's disappointed that LaQuinton Evans, Smoke, as they call him here for Southern, that he hasn't had more of an opportunity today to be heavily involved in the offense, because they really feel like he is the level of player that would be able to succeed in the National Football League.
J.P. Douglas, the true freshman quarterback who started this game, on the sideline watching Dre Joseph operate the Jaguar offense now. And wisely just gets rid of that one to avoid the sack. And Anthony was talking about Stump Mitchell, and he wants versatile players. We do have a flag down on this play. We'll check in with Roderick Holloway momentarily. So Stump Mitchell wants the versatility from his players. Well, he was a versatile running back. 85, 86, and 87. 40 or more catches for the St. Louis Cardinals. Also an excellent return man. Dre Joseph fires, puts it right on Michael Berry, and the ball knocked loose. Incomplete pass. Would have been a gain of 14 had he hung on. Penalty marker on the play.
Offside, 99, defense, 5-yard penalty, replay, third down.
You know, Paul, I'll say this. I like the referee, Roderick Holloway, but I've seen a little bit too much of him today. He needs to huddle that group together and say, hey, guys,
want him to keep it moving.
Yeah, just keep this laundry, you know, tucked in the pants.
Good job by David Stuckman jarring that ball loose. So, Sean, you played quarterback right in this building for Tulane. I believe you led the Green Wave to an undefeated season back in 98. As we watch Dre Joseph step up in the pocket. That pass hauled in by Lee Doss gets out of bounds right at the sticks.
We actually have a banner that hangs in the
I saw that.
Superdome. I was very fortunate, Paul, to be around some great people. You know, gave me an opportunity to succeed, and I bought into Tommy Bowden, Rich Rodriguez, what they were preaching, and, you know, that's the result of it. You know, not many, you know, teams, players, you know, can say they've been associated with something that was perfect. And, you know, in 1998, you know, the city of New Orleans, you know, the students, faculty, staff, athletes at Tulane University got to be a part of something that was really special.
Dre Joseph. Misfiring that time, little low to Charles Hawkins, and you're awfully kind there, giving credit to teammates and coaches, but I believe that you threw 38 touchdowns and 6 interceptions. Is that, am I remembering that correctly?
I was decent. The 6 picks, I'm still upset about those.
Yeah. What do you remember living here in the mid to late 90s and being the football fan that you are about this rivalry and being around the Bayou Classic as a student athlete at Tulane?
I mean, there are a couple of things that you wanted to be associated with every year that come to the city of New Orleans, and the Bayou Classic is one of them. You know, a lot of times we would not go home for Thanksgiving so that we could stay and just participate in the festivities. And it was just a wonderful experience, and I'm glad that I was able to be a part of it. You know, interestingly, you know, the freshman quarterback at Southern, J.P. Douglas, I was having a conversation with him yesterday. He still hasn't really jumped all the way into this Louisiana culture. You know, I asked him, I said, have you tried any of the local cuisine? I mean, have you had any boudin sausage? Have you had any jambalaya and gumbo? And he was like, you know, Mr. King, he called Mr. King, he made me feel old. He said, Mr.
Polite.
King, I just stay in the room and study.
He's pre-med major.
Yeah.
Studying biology, probably got to spend a lot of time with the playbook as well.
The most amazing food in the world is right here in the city of New Orleans.
I've heard that often. Didn't get a chance to experience it. Dre Joseph dumping off underneath. Michael Berry breaking tackles. Picks up one. And that'll bring up fourth down and 9 for the Southern offense, trailing 36-12 as we are now inside of 5 minutes in the 38th annual State Farm Bayou Classic. Southern Jaguars had won 2 out of 3 games coming into this one. Had they won this game, would have been a 4-way tie atop the Western Division of the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Grambling State, winners of 5 consecutive, get close to 6 in a row. That was close to an interception, but falls incomplete on fourth down. And the Grambling offense will take over.
And you talk about the state of Louisiana and some of, you know, those attributes that it has. A lot of good things happening down the road in Baton Rouge as the LSU finished their regular season last night with a very impressive victory over Arkansas, who was actually number 3 in the BCS. When you look at what they've been able to accomplish this year, who they've beaten, I mean, great job by Les Miles and his staff.
And what a weekend for football here in Southern Louisiana. You mentioned the LSU big win over Arkansas. Today we have the 38th annual Bayou Classic, and Monday night right inside this building, Monday Eli night Manning before. Coming home to his hometown of New Orleans to take on the Saints.
You know, I've always thought, Paul, that has to be one of the thorns in the side of LSU football, that neither Eli or Peyton decided to attend LSU, and both being from Louisiana, that's got to be a sore spot.
In the substitution, well, man, in the formation on the defense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Sunday night is football night. Don't miss America's game of the week as the Steelers take on the Chiefs on Sunday Night Football. Bob Costas hosts Football Night in America live from Kansas City. Coverage begins at 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, only on NBC.
I love Sunday Night Football in America. Dan and Tony and Ryan, they do such a great job.
Good watch every single time. Backup quarterback in is Frank Rivers.
You know, Paul, but I'll be honest, I don't know who Coach Haley knows down in Kansas City, but it seems like Kansas City's been on the national TV game about 5 times this year.
The Chiefs won the AFC West last year. I mean, there was a lot of excitement coming into this season, and Arrowhead Stadium always a festive atmosphere, as we mentioned. New quarterback Frank Rivers leading the way. Frank started 5 games middle of this season before giving way to the freshman DJ Williams. Not quite as efficient from the pocket as DJ. Frank, just a little under 50%, 48%. And 10 touchdowns is good, but 10 interceptions maybe a little too high.
And again, Paul, another big kid. You know, DJ stands 6'5". Frank comes into the game 6'5", 205. I mentioned to Doug, I say you got to stop discriminating against the short quarterbacks like myself. He's got all these 6'5 guys on the sideline. I wouldn't have had a chance at Grambling.
Frank Rivers, backup quarterback, running the show now as we approach the 4-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Tigers just keep this one on the ground, want to keep that clock moving with a 36-12 lead. Think about all the different ways Doug Williams could be described on this day, Sean. Okay, you have Grambling graduate, son of two Grambling graduates, and the father of the starting quarterback. Head coach, most prolific quarterback in school history, and the man who succeeded Eddie Robinson, and I'm not done yet, Grambling's first quarterback in the Bayou Classic and the last Tiger to be drafted in the first round back in 1978.
And two of his daughters have graduated from Grambling, so you know that Williams name is definitely associated on part of the lineage, tradition, and history, you know, of this wonderful institution.
Clock ticking now at 3:16. Tigers with a 24-point lead. More ground game. Jawan Martin. Today's State Farm players of the game are from Grambling State University, Mario Lewis. It's not a bad touchdown ratio there. 3 TDs on 4 catches. And Jamie Payton, the linebacker for Southern, was outstanding today.
And Mario has a nickname, Super, and he definitely was very, very super today in his performance. Made some outstanding catches. And Jamie Payton, his defense gave up 36, but that should not overshadow the individual effort that he put in today in the Bayou Classic.
Mario Lewis now with 17 touchdown receptions this season, easily the leader in that category in the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Kenneth Batiste, did he stay in bounds? Looks like he got out of bounds, and the clock stops at 2:11 remaining.
To put a bow on that Mario Lewis storyline, we should really make sure we emphasize the fact that this guy's only played wide receiver for just over 3.5 years at this point, just about to finish his fourth season of playing football, like no high school football at all. And Doug Williams jokes about the fact that he had that Michael Jordan syndrome. Mario Lewis in high school thought he was going to be an NBA basketball player, but now once they got him here, played some intramural football for Grambling, and at some point, the coaches saw him. He came out, didn't make the football team the first time he tried to come out, but then he was persistent about it and came back out. Now in his senior season, most definitely the top NFL prospect they've got in the SWAC.
And making this extra special for him, and this is Batiste bursting inside the 40-yard line. Mario Lewis from the New Orleans area, L.W. Higgins High School in Marrero. 4 catches and 3 touchdowns today as we are now down inside of 2 minutes.
And you know, the same thing that happened to me happened to Mario. You know, I thought I was going to be a college basketball player, NBA player. I stopped growing.
For real?
Yeah, I stopped growing. I got to 6'1 and didn't get any taller.
What was your game? Point guard? You posted people up?
I just like to shoot.
That's really hard to believe.
Really?
I was the same way. I recognize that. First down and 10 now. Clock ticking now at 1:15. Doug Williams going to get a bath over there on the Grambling sideline. Batiste cutting his way inside to the 37-yard line. We mentioned that Doug came into this 1-5 as a coach against Grambling. How's that second win feel, coach?
Feels oh so good. You see his senior linebacker, Cliff Exama, who missed this game last year. He talked about how much it meant for him to play, and that's just a wonderful, wonderful feeling for Doug Williams. I know to have his son here with him at Grambling, he's back at the alma mater, the place that he loves, and for DJ to perform the way that he did today. This will be one of those memories that will last forever in the Williams household.
DJ performing very well, Sean. 11 out of 17, 174 yards, three touchdowns, all to Mario Lewis to go along with his one interception. This will be the final play of the game. Frank Rivers takes a knee, and that number six on his jersey means something. Six victories in a row for Doug Williams' Grambling State Tigers, and four consecutive victories in the Bayou Classic. Doug Williams Tigers on their way to the SWAC title game December 10th in Birmingham, Alabama. DJ Williams, the freshman quarterback for his father. Doug Williams coming through in a big way, a big second half for the Tigers. Offense, defense, and special teams. 36 to 12, the final. Tigers will have an off week. Take those six wins in a row to the SWAC title game December 10th. Celebration for the Tigers side inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Once again, the final score is Grambling 36, Southern 12. Tomorrow, Sunday Night Football. Well, it's football night as the Steelers take on the Chiefs on Sunday Night Football. Bob Costas hosts Football Night in America live from Kansas City beginning at 7 o'clock Eastern. Tonight at 8, 7 Central, it's an NBC special, the 85th anniversary of the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade, followed by the NBC Movie of the Week, The B-Movie. For Sean King, Anthony Heron, and Lewis Johnson, I'm Paul Burmeister. Grambling, your winner, 36 to 12.